Stevenson kicks off. And it's returnable for Hines Ward, the senior for ex-Georgia. He found a couple of seams and is trying to get outside. Stevenson, the kicker, in pursuit. Hines Ward into Florida territory with the opening kickoff. Out of bounds at the 47-yard line, knocked out by Rod Brady. A 50-yard kickoff return.
Hines Ward may be the most versatile player in college football today. He plays wide receiver, quarterback, running back, returns kicks. Here he finds a crease in the coverage that Florida has, and he does a lot of it on his own, and a tremendous big play for Georgia to get off on a great start.
And they could use a confidence boost to begin the game. They've been throttled by the Gators in recent years. Last year they lost 47-7. Ward looking to throw off reverse, and it is overthrown. Corey Allen had pulled up at about the 22-yard line, and the pass was long. Fred Weary had the coverage. John into the bag of tricks early. Mike Bobo has completely turned around his touchdown and interception numbers from a year ago. Last year he threw 16 interceptions. This season, a league low 2. He's a senior from Thomasville, Georgia. Not far from the Florida border near Tallahassee. Jim Donnan, his second year as Georgia coach, looking to end this Florida winning streak over the Bulldogs. On second and 10, Robert Edwards down to the 44 for a gain of 3. Now the rest of the Georgia offensive starters. Edwards opens in the backfield with Patrick Pass. Larry Brown is the tight end with Hines Ward and Corey Allen, the wideouts. And a solid offensive line at Stinchcomb, Steve Herndon, Brad Stapp, Antonio Fleming, and Chris Terry, Jacksonville native at right tackle. Georgia Bulldogs. Down and 7. Edwards, the lone back, lined up to the right of Bobo. The shotgun. Bobo lost it deep. Allen jump ball, and it is intercepted on a deflection. Picked off by Tony.
On this particular theory, number 24 of Florida, he can really lock on to Corey Allen, number 80. Mike Bobo, actually the wide receiver's covered. Bobo throws it up. Corey Allen does a great job of leaping for the ball to catch behind him. And Tony George, number 1 with the action. But in terms of the field position, it's a good punt if you look at it like that. It was third down. It's like not converting and punting the ball dead inside the 10 for Georgia.
Second interception season for Tony George. On first down for Florida, Paul Snelling, the tackle on Fred Taylor, the leading ball carrier. Doug Johnson has led the game 3 weeks since LSU lost, the only loss of the season for Florida, a game in which he threw 4 interceptions. A couple of nights before that game, he violated the team curfew. Wasn't discovered that he had done that until after the LSU game, so he was suspended for the last game against Auburn 2 weeks ago. Taylor stopped by Greg Bright, Georgia's leading tackler, at the 13-yard line. Brandon Tolbert also in on the stop on Taylor. And it'll be third down for the Gators. Just underway and no score. The 5th different offensive line for Florida, providing holes it hopes for this group. Taylor and Frazier in the backfield, with Kinney the tight end. And there is the 5th different offensive line to start a game this season, because Pat Browning is a first-time starter this year. He's moved in a tackle for the Gators. Doug Johnson in trouble, throws, and it is incomplete. And Kinney and broken up forward, so the Gators will have to punt from their own 13-yard line.
Sean, it's really important that Georgia gets off to a good start. One of the things that Florida loves to do is dominate a game early with their offensive team. Get you way behind, and all of a sudden you get behind, and pressure starts to mount. Georgia defensive series here is excellent. 3 down, out. That creates confidence on the sideline. Jim is going to get over. over and say, hey, guys, we can play with Florida.
Robbie Stevenson kicking with the beer. We got a rush from Champ Bailey, but it's a good punt and a fair catch called for made by Michael Greer back at the 38-yard line. 58-yard punt and no return. Each team has had the ball once without scoring.
Scoreless here in Jacksonville, where Florida linebacker Johnny Rutledge suddenly took ill on the Florida bench. He had food poisoning on Monday, practice Tuesday, and he was fine all day today until this. They rehydrated, and they hope to get him back in. Back now to Sean and Terry.
As we saw, he's on the bench at the moment. Movement along the right end of the offensive line. Chris Terry came out of his stance. He's a converted defensive tackle playing.
False start. On the offense, 5-yard penalty.
Offensive tackle this season, and that's been a key move for the Georgia offense this season.
Well, Chris Terry's an interesting story. He gained 200 pounds since arriving at Georgia when he did arrive as a defensive player. As you mentioned, Sean, he's a very agile player. He's a great pass blocker, has a big old wingspan on him, and he's really grown into being an offensive tackle.
Mike Bobo on first and 15 throws, and a great catch made by Larry Brown. Bobo looks a little shaky early, not exactly zipping the ball with great confidence. Brown was wide open, but had to make an acrobatic catch for a gain out to the 44-yard line.
Mike Bobo is one of the real keys to this offense today. Jim Donnan told us earlier in the week, he's got to play well. He does a good job of getting rid of the ball. The ball's high, but sometimes you got to be saved by your receivers. And that receiver steps up and makes the play.
See, Bobo gone out as a wideout now, and Hines Ward is in at quarterback. They want to run some wide. LSU had success in its win against Florida with the option, and Florida didn't seem surprised at all by that. Darrell Owens, with the illness, dropped that play for no gain. It'll be third down and six.
Watch middle linebacker. Comes from that area of the screen. Middle linebackers are to stay free. Linemen keep them free so they can make plays. Darrell Owens, 56, makes a perfect play for a middle linebacker.
Darrell's a redshirt freshman from Jackson, Mississippi. Bob Stoops, the defensive coordinator, says he has great for the game. Now Bobo back at quarterback. He's going to have Ward throw again. Man open, Brown the tight end. Rumbling into Florida territory with a first down at the 29-yard line. Tico Brown, the safety, made the tackle.
Jim Donnan getting into the bag of tricks early. Sometimes you want to watch the tight end. He comes across the formation here. They fake the reverse, and all of a sudden, Hines Ward pulls the ball down from the reverse and hits the wide open tight end. The secondary from Florida has supported. He's just wide open in that seam. Larry Brown, number 87, with the reception.
Jim Donnan told us they haven't been throwing much to the tight end lately. They wanted to get back to the tight end today, and they have a couple of early catches for Larry Brown. Olandis Gary down to the 27-yard line, a short gain. Here's the Florida defense, outstanding up front with Willie Rogers, Mike Moten, Reggie McGrew, and Willie Cohen. Johnny Rutledge not feeling well at the moment. Dwayne Thomas and Mike Peterson, the line picking. Elijah Williams, Tony George, Tico Brown, and Fred Weary, comprising one of the best secondary in the nation.
You have to like the way George has come out and really been aggressive. Kickoff return, reverse pass.
Edwards, nice inside, still going. Touchdown!
Sometimes offensive tackles don't get enough credit. Watch Matt Stinchcomb. He buries his man, and Orlandis Gary, 22, goes in there and makes a great block from the fullback position. Robert Edwards walks in there untouched. A huge start for the Georgia Bulldogs.
And the point is barely by half highs. A 27-yard touchdown run for Robert Edwards. 7-0 Bulldogs.
You're buying a car. Use car you want. And which car you don't want. But there are still cars out there that you don't know that you do want. Recent Oldsmobile caught with so many new models, they might not be on your list yet. They should be. So before you buy, find out all you can. Come to Oldsmobile's 100th anniversary premiere and test one. Or call toll-free to find out.
Reaching your financial goals can be a complex balancing act. At the Principal Financial Group, you'll find the strength of our investment performance is your 401k retirement advantage. You'll find our flexibility will meet your insurance needs. And you'll find the balance of choice and quality you need in health coverage. For over 100 years, the Principal has made the complex simple. That's how we give you an edge. The Principal.
Jim Dunnan runs a sweep on that play. Edwards, watch the foot right here. He makes key block on the linebacker. You can't run offense to open end side if you don't get good blocking by the front and by those backs. Edwards, the leading rusher at Georgia. This guy's been hampered by injuries. The last four games, he's finally been healthy. He adds a whole new dimension to the Georgia offensive attack.
And Bobby is defensive lecture. The squib kick is a free ball at the 37-yard line. Mark Judson's kickoff right along the ground. It bounced up and struck Tim Beauchamp, one of the up men for Florida. And the Gators got it back. Fortunately for Florida, like Dwayne Thomas came up with the ball. He and Thaddeus Bullard were at the bottom of the pile. It might have Bullard number 11. But a scare for the Gators.
Florida is a great kickoff return team, so Georgia counters that kickoff return with a little squib kick. Oftentimes, those players that are in the wall aren't really good with their hands. That particular case was an example. The ball bounced free. Florida very fortunate to get it back.
And much better field position for the Gators' second possession. And a handoff to Bo Carroll. He's a track All-American with tremendous speed. And that's a gain of 10, very close to a first down at the 47-yard line. Here's the Georgia defense, Paul Snelling, Travis Stroud, Derek Bird, and Antonio Cochran up front. The linebackers are Brandon Talbert, Greg Bright, and Arontis Grant. And in the secondary, Champ Bailey will be running with Jaquez Green most of the day. Glenn Ford, Kirby Smart, and Ronald Bailey. Champ's older brother for Joe Kines, whom we saw a moment ago, the Georgia defensive coordinator. It was a gain of 9 for Carroll. And that Taylor pulls forward for the first down, tackled by Paul Snelling.
You know, we're seeing a different Florida team, and the reason is because of the experience of quarterback. Florida is going to play somewhat conservative. They're going to try to get the running game going with Taylor and Carroll. They've got two out. They'll throw the ball to Johnson. He's going to air it out, but it's not the same style of attack, play in and play out. And why is so? Got a great defense. You want to play conservative football at times.
Out of the shotgun on first down, down the middle, incomplete. The man was open. The pass from Doug Johnson a bit too long for Jamie Richardson at about the 22-yard line. Florida has dominated its opponents this season in the first quarter. But the Georgia touchdown, it's still 108-1 in favor of Florida against their foes this year.
But Joe,
the edge at every quarter, but particularly in the first.
But Joe Kine, the defensive coordinator at Florida, was talking to us this week, and he said, if I can just get my defense off to a decent start, come out of the gate fast, get some confidence as the game goes along, we have a lot better chance to play.
Second hand, the pass caught by Richardson. He's short of a first down at the 44-yard line.
I met Joe.
2.5 yards shy of the first down, tackled by Greg Bright and Jeff Harris.
Joe Kines at Georgia, the defensive coordinator. That's who I was referring to right there. He's done a great job with this defense.
Last week, the Georgia defense held Kentucky to a season low 13 points. Even though the Wildcats moved the ball up and down the field, it was the ultimate bend but don't break defensive performance by Georgia. Third down and three. The handoff to Taylor. And he has the first down. Down to the 41. Gained the first down by about a yard. Arontis Grant tripped him up.
It's a little counter play that Florida runs. Rylage, 51. He's the lead blocker, the left guard. He's going to be the guy who pulls right there. You can follow him. And then they give the ball to the leading rusher in the conference, Fred Taylor. He's a powerful back. The guy can make yards. He has outstanding vision and cutting ability.
Back to the pass on first and 10. That is thrown up for grabs and intercepted. No receiver in the area. It's Champ Bailey out of bounds for Georgia at the 26-yard line. Reminiscent of the LSU game, that throw by Dutch Johnson. And everything is going Georgia's way early in Jacksonville.
There's real outstanding pressure put on by the Georgia front. The defensive tackle, number 94, Leroy, he gets the pressure on Johnson. Johnson unloads the ball. As you mentioned, Sean, there isn't a receiver within 20 yards of that. It's just a busted play.
Third interception of the season for Champ Bailey, the sophomore from Folkston, Georgia.
A company most people never heard of is changing the way we fight cancer and kidney failure. By inducing the body to produce blood cells, chemotherapy and anemia patients are gaining new strength. Helping to grow blood cells helps Amgen become the world's largest biotech company. Where do you learn about companies with such pioneering spirit? Exactly. NASDAQ.com.
You know, when you're coughing and your headaches, every mattress says, lie down, rest.
But the boss says, hustle, sale starts in 10 minutes.
Yeah, sure.
That does nothing for cost. My motto is, NyQuil for night, DayQuil for day. I'll share with you.
I'll be fine.
If you love the complete relief of NyQuil, you'll love its non-drowsy daytime version called DayQuil.
I was willing to share.
Vicks DayQuil, the non-drowsy stuffy head, sore throat, coughing, fever, so you can get through your day medicine.
There are millions of reasons to fly today. You want to be Delta Airlines on top of the world.
On NASCAR doubleheader, first the Grand Nationals go for it at their grand finale, then the Super Truckers settle it at their season-ending showdown next Sunday on CBS.
Altel Stadium in Jacksonville, formerly the Gator Bowl, spectacular set of neutral site in this rivalry. The tickets evenly divided. And Georgia has the ball first and 10 at its own 27 after the interception. Bailey, Bobo sidestepped the rush, but they got him behind. That's the first Florida sack. The ball came out, but Bobo was ruled down. Willie Cohen put Bobo to the turf.
Tim Beauchamp, the defensive end, 93. He's going to apply the pressure, but Mike Bobo does a good job here. Yes, he takes a sack, but what he doesn't do, he doesn't panic in the pocket. He pulls the ball down. He lives to fight another play. I think that's outstanding play by a quarterback against a top-ranked defense like Florida has.
They average 5 sacks per game on pace for the conference record. Bobo caught. First down, Tony Small. Out to the 39-yard line goes the Jacksonville native with his first reception of the game. Let's go to New York, and here's Jim Nance.
All right, fellas, is this the second-best team in the country? Last outing, Penn State nipped Minnesota by 1 today against Northwestern. And just a moment ago, the Wildcats scored in the final half minute, Brian Musso, but they failed to recover the onside kick. Nittany Lions stay unbeaten with a 3-point victory. Next week, it's Michigan. Let's go back to Sean and Terry.
Thank you, Jim. A win for Penn State, but perhaps again not convinced enough as those teams jockey for position atop the polls.
I would say that's a marginal win in terms of how the pollsters are. For a coach, there is no marginal win. Joe Paterno's got to be happy with the victory.
After the 18-yard gain on the pass play to Small, Georgia goes back to win with Patrick Pass. Pass running out of bounds at the 49, close to another first down by Mike Harris.
Jim Donnan, the head coach of Georgia, who serves as his own offensive coordinator, he told us this week that he was going to run plays that attack the Florida defense quickly. Try not to run through a lot. Right at them. This is a little lead draw that slices right defense fast. As a result of that, you have positive yards off the field. Hines Ward trying to get off coverage. He's having a real battle with Tony George. I wonder about wide receivers and DBs. That's what happens on a running play.
Second and one, Edwards. Advances for the first down as he moved across midfield and went down to the 49-yard line. Edwards coming off the biggest game of his career, 186-yard long touchdown by Kentucky.
They're a different team on with Robert Edwards being able to shoot the ball like he's capable of. It gives them real balance. It gives them the fact they can run and throw. It really is much more difficult on a defense.
Injured Gator is Dwayne Thomas. Florida already with a problem at linebacker today with the illness to Johnny Rutledge, who, as Michelle told you, has had a tough time bouncing back from food poisoning earlier in the week, and now it's Thomas being assisted by the Florida medical staff. Dwayne's the middle linebacker, senior, another Jacksonville native playing in his hometown today, the first member of his family to go to college. And that's good to see. He's up on his feet, trotting off.
As good a team as Florida is, they can ill afford to continue to lose starters in their defensive unit. You've got to have your best players on the field to play their best. And Florida has a fired-up Georgia team on their hands right now.
Mike Peterson, another starting linebacker, is also on the right now for Florida. Hines Ward. Back at Kirby. Pitch it to Bailey. A two-way player for Georgia. That razzle-dazzle didn't yield much. Perhaps 2 yards, maybe a yard and a half before Tony George knocked Champ Bailey out of bounds.
Tony George made a great play. He went all the way across the field, and he was covering Champ Bailey man-to-man, which as a coach, you tell him, you take him anywhere he goes. As a reverse search the form, Tony George comes all the way over across the field. That's a marvelous play by a strong safety athlete.
Junior for Cincinnati. Bailey, the first two-way player at Georgia since James Warner back in 1991. Warner played 10 and linebacker against Kentucky. Bobo going deep, and it is intercepted. Elijah Williams with his first of the season. And runs back to the 40-yard line. He's thrown in the first quarter today.
Georgia had hurt Florida earlier in the game with a post. Hines Ward is going to run down the field and then break inside to the post. Elijah Williams plays perfect underneath technique. He had help over the top. He could go underneath to make that interception. That's a great play by one of the real outstanding players at Georgia. You're looking at an offensive player converted to defense just in spring practice.
It goes back to the comment that we were making at the beginning of the telecast. Jim Donnan saying Bobo had to be very accurate today because the receivers won't have much breathing room. With some room, Jacquez Green, he has a first down into Georgia territory at the 42-yard line, an 18-yard gain for the junior, a Georgia native playing for Florida.
Jacquez Green is one of the guys, when you're playing against Florida, you better keep track of. He's dangerous from all over the field. He runs side routes behind him. He makes a very athletic move to adjust first down for the Gators.
10-0, Georgia. 5.5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Middle screen thrown by Johnson, and that is dropped for a loss. Fred Taylor tackled by Antonio Cochran back at the 43-yard line. Two weeks ago, against Auburn, we saw the versatility of Jacquez Green. He threw a touchdown pass to Jamie Richardson in the quarter. In the third quarter, he caught a touchdown pass. And then on the reverse, in the 5-yard run, Other than that, he didn't do much against the Tigers. Willie's Burger told us he thinks he's outrunning Bill Sutton there. Johnson on target for game to the 37-yard line. Rod Frazier, the fullback, out of the field for just his seventh catch of the year. Jeff Harris made that goal.
Sean, when you're on the sideline in a big game like this is, Florida, Georgia, you always try to get a sense of how the other team is playing. As I watch Georgia play right now, they're playing with an extra step of quickness. They're breaking on the ball. They're rallying to ball carriers. They're very, very aggressive. Steve Spurrier has a fired-up Georgia team on his hands.
Out of the shotgun, Johnson after a pump fake throws. Green has the first down. Down to the 26-yard line. Arontis Grant made the tackle.
Arontis Grant makes the stop.
Gain of 11 on the play. Green, as we mentioned, a Georgia native. Third in the NCAA, non-touchdown receptions. Fort Valley, Georgia, down to about 8,000 in southern Georgia. Said everybody around him growing up was a Georgia fan, but said he didn't want to go to school where they lost three or four games a year.
Such smooth athlete, watching the running cut.
Change of play, there's Green again. Tackled around the ankle by Champ Billy. They're inside and on the ground. Second down and short at the 18.
Jaquez Green came into this game with 43 receptions. The next quarter receiver, Jamie Richardson, 80. That's how important this guy is to the Seaspur is a master at getting the ball in his best player's hands. Green, Fred Taylor, those are the guys in for games.
Taylor handed it back. Johnson after the pitch. Johnson to the end zone. Blocked. Oh, that had a touchdown all over it, but Jamie Richardson blocked it in the end zone.
Both coaches showing a lot of razzle dazzle, if you will. Trick type plays. This is a play designed to pitch the ball back, flip it back to the quarterback. The Florida offensive line did a tremendous job giving Doug Johnson nothing but time to throw the ball. Should have been a touchdown by the Gators.
Third down and two, 7-0 Georgia. 3:04 remaining in the first quarter. Taylor stacked up, got back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. He is short of the first down. Greg Bright made the primary hit. It'll be fourth down and a yard, perhaps a yard and a half, and it looks like Steve Spurrier is going to go for it.
Joe Kines, the defensive coordinator of Georgia, says all day long, Greg Bright and Arontis Grant, they are going to follow the tailback all over the field. Fred Taylor, that's exactly what happened on that play. They met him right in the hole.
The pitch to Taylor on fourth and a yard. The first down. We'll see from the marker on the near side, as you see, looks to have, but that is not lined up on the far sideline.
Sean, I'm not sure he made it.
No.
The spot does.
He was confused by this marker on the near side, marking the line of scrimmage. I'm not sure he does have it from which lead to chance. Greg Bright made the tackle. He has to get down and take a look, and then he says, first down, Georgia. By an inch short, too.
You talk about football being a game of inches. That's referred to all the time. An inch here, an inch there. Florida goes ahead and runs the sweep. Georgia did a good job stretching the sidelines, so Fred Taylor didn't have a seam to really go up in there. Joe Kine, I think he's. He did a great job last week against Kentucky's offense as well.
Former defensive coordinator at Florida back in the late 70s and early 80s. So the Georgia defense holds an inch on fourth down at about a yard. And it's trying to get outside. By Collins. Away from Collins. First down and more. He's tackled out of bounds at the 31-yard line. Tony George made the tackle, a gain of 15.
There is some tremendous blocking going on in the Georgia offensive line, but I'll tell you what else is happening. Tony Small, number 9, along with Hines Ward, these guys are blocking on the perimeter, and number 80, Corey Allen, just dominated the defensive back that time. That's what allowed the play to get down the field. Corey Allen, he's the guy that's going to get the rave reviews in the film room on that play.
Edwards averaging 12 yards per rush on 4 carries today. Already has the only touchdown of the game from 27 yards out on the run. And he's ahead for a couple more. Out to the 33. Let's go back to that fourth down play.
Well, you talk about momentum jerseys. Every game has certainly dictated the momentum of the game. This, as Georgia looked at the game, certainly in the first quarter, this is an important defensive stop. Again, going back to Georgia's philosophy, let's play well early. Let's not let Florida jump on us. Steve Spurrier could get impatient if things don't pick up for his offensive team.
Some say this rivalry has lost 100 years with the Florida domination, but you wouldn't know it in talking to Spurrier because he was in two against Georgia in 1966, and they're 7-0, and Divas way past the hand. Pass and very nearly intercepted. Works up a healthy disregard for the Bulldogs when this game comes around. Here's Michelle Tafoya.
Well, that's for his linebacking core taking it on the chin today. Dwayne Thomas has a shoulder burner. He should. Mike Peterson has his right knee. He's out the remainder of this half. He'll be re-examined at halftime to determine whether or not he'll return at all. And when teammates have come up and asked him how he is, he simply will not respond. Guys.
Boy, I mentioned earlier, he did a lot of tackling up to the game.
Peterson may be their best defensive player, and they have a lot of good ones, but he is a factor.
They didn't get the playoff. You saw the play clock run out before the snap. Difficult to hear the whistle with the tremendous noise generated by this capacity crowd in Jacksonville.
Delay of game. 5-yard penalty on the offense. Third down.
You know, as Michelle was saying, when you start taking players like Peterson, Johnny Rutledge, Dwayne Thomas, all of a sudden your defensive structure can change dramatically. You win with players. You have to have the dominant players on the field. Florida's got some real dominant athletes on defense, but if they're off that field, Georgia's going to be able to move the ball more consistently.
Rare penalty against Georgia, the least penalized team in the conference by far coming into today's game. Bobo stepped up into the pocket, threw for Hines Ward. Weary right there to swing him back. It'll give Ward forward progress to the 35, but that's about 6 yards short of first down. And George will be forced to punt. Under a minute remaining in the first quarter. Georgia leads 7-0 on a 27-yard touchdown run by Robert Edwards. Next, Langley is the Georgia punter. Averaging just more than 40 yards per kick. Jacquez Green back to receive it. Not had a punt blocked in his career. 163 now without a block. That's a good punt. Green at the 17. Green across the 30 and he runs out of bounds at the 5-yard line. 48-yard punt, 18-yard return for Jacquez Green. Today, aerial shots are being provided by the Bud One Airship, which reminds you that fresh beer tastes better. And the folks, the world's largest outdoor cocktail party, I'm sure you need that reminder. It has lived up to that reputation this weekend here in Jacksonville. Just 8 seconds left in the quarter. Fred Taylor, the lone back, faked that handoff back to Johnson. And it's a gain of perhaps a yard for Taylor on the final play of the quarter. And a surprising first quarter it has been. The score, Georgia 7 and Florida nothing. We'll return to Altel Stadium in Jacksonville right after this message and a word from your local station.
Your heart's pounding, adrenaline's pumping.
They light you up.
And you go.
We asked some of Hollywood's hottest stuntmen to switch antiperspirants and try Degree.
What's body heat activate? Probably means when you get warm, that starts working.
As your body heat rises, Degree releases extra protection.
I heat it up, and it cooled me down.
I was on fire, and I was dry.
I don't think I've seen these wet. Just stuck up, even in the 40-foot high pool. Dry as a baby.
Body heat activated Degree. Your body heat turned on.
DocuPrint and 32. It prints 32 pages a minute. It's soft to and can stay like this and this. Xerox does. Tell them what P would be.
The document company. Xerox.
And the address is CBS. Welcome home.
There's a couple new outfits at Gerald Jones Honda, the all-new 98 Accord and Passport.
The new Accord is much larger, has tons of features, comes with an optional 200 horsepower V6. It's an Accord like no other. Plus, many model prices nearly 1,000 last year. Also, to this drive our other new arrival, the Passport, an SUV like no other.
This is the most exciting time in Honda history. See us at Gerald Jones. It's Honda time.
At Nevada Pause. Find the lowest prices on golf equipment, and right now you can save up to 30% during our fall clearance sale.
Choose from a huge selection of name brand clubs, bags, apparel, shoes, and more, and save up to 30%.
Nevada Bob's is the largest chain of golf stores in the world, and will sell the greatest names in golf for less. Nevada Bob's Professional Golf in the Village West Shopping Center behind Dairy Queen. It's the best drive you'll make all day.
Hi, I'm David Holt, president of Georgia Carolina Forest Products. Timber, like other crops, should be managed and harvested on a periodic basis. We at Georgia Carolina strive to be environmentally aware in the harvesting of timber. We pay top market prices for your timber. We'll buy by the ton or pay you for the entire track in advance. So if you're 7 acres more and are interested in harvesting, call Georgia Carolina Forest Products.
Surf the net with Channel 12, RDRES, WRDW.com.
The banks of renovated a couple of years ago for the arrival of the Jacksonville Jaguars. What a great facility. Now, Doug Johnson throws on second out. And that pass is caught by Eugene McCaslin. He caught his way first down. Rontus Grant made the tackle. Let the Gators move the chains. A lot of action in that first quarter. Both coaches, offensive coordinators, both deep into the bag of tricks.
Well, no question about that. What has surprised me thus far is the defensive and offensive lines of Georgia. They're certainly holding their own against Florida. And if this continues, they'll be able to match up very well. I thought the Florida defensive line would kind of dominate their offense, and it happened that way.
On first and 10, Fred Taylor hit at the line of scrimmage. Ahead to get back to the line. Travis Stroud made the stop with help from Derek for the Bulldog defense. Stroud, a senior from Atlanta, and Bird, a profile in persistence. He's bounced back from two reconstructive knee surgeries, the days when those knees are very sore, but he's still out there playing.
Georgia defensive line is hanging in there against that big Florida offensive line.
From their own 46, second and 10 for the Gators. Doug Johnson hit as he threw it, and it is intercepted. Kirby Smart, who had two last week against Kentucky, has his fifth of the season and the second of the day for Georgia.
Sometimes a quarterback just can't get planted. Watch. He's work about Pat Browning, a new right tackle for Florida. Browning got too wide on his pass rush set. Talbert came underneath him and really pressured Johnson. You can't always blame a quarterback for interception. Sometimes it's pressure.
Today, instead of sitting window watching,
life go by, people are out there doing, pushing themselves beyond the norm. And no muscle ache will bring them down. No headache limit their imagination. Because today, we have an advanced medicine for pain called Advil. It's remarkable just how fast Advil works right side of body pain, stopping it where it starts. The relief is glorious. Headaches to muscles. Advil relieves all kinds of pain for so many people. Advil simply lets people do what they love to do.
Some of Goodyear's best selected tires like Aqua Treads, Eagles, and Wranglers, and get $50 or $75 good towards officially licensed NFL merchandise at participating Goodyear retailers. Call 1-800-GOODYEAR. Great Goodyear Treads. Incredible NFL Treads.
Isn't that a pretty sight?
So how many miles? 50?
90. 90,000 miles. Dude, that's just getting broke in for Chevy.
Is that a scratch?
Scratches give character.
The best long-term quality of any full-size pickup belongs to Chevy.
Women like character.
Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Woof! What'd you step in?
You know, the only way to eat Hardee's new Big West Bacon Cheeseburger is with total concentration. That way you can appreciate all the things that make it so great. Like two big beef patties, three strips of bacon, melting cheese, a ton of barbecue sauce, and a huge roll. Big West Bacon Cheeseburger. Only at Hardee's.
Joggers.
Power Towel News Belt has joined forces to bring the weather to the passage happening in your neighborhood. Stations will be placed in schools throughout our area, with students using the information in classes daily. And you'll get the latest weather results from your neighborhood on New 12. You can see our first weather unit now on Port Discovery. PowerTel is the first to launch fully digital wireless PCS service in Augusta and Aiken. And again, rushing the neighborhood weather net. The weather you are.
Baby, come on. I'm sorry. We'll never go there again.
We'll go to Amoco. Get some
ultimates. And we can drive around the park.
A veiled threat. Other times you'd make it remain. In Steve's case, I don't have any idea, but I do think that he has a certain level of frustration right now with his quarterback play. I think that's evident.
Yesterday, certain who the backup quarterback would be should Johnson go out. Bobo throws into traffic, and it's incomplete. Off the hands of Jermaine Wiggins, the second-string tight end. It was a catchable ball, but Wiggins couldn't haul it in. And it's three plays on a punt for Georgia, and the Gator fans are on their feet.
That's kind of the first series for Georgia that hasn't really gone the way they planned it. That kind of was a series that they'd just as soon forget. The other series had some excitement in them, some real striking capabilities, and some daring. Jim Donnan pulling out all the stops for the Georgia Bulldogs in terms of offensively. He's really going after after Florida's offense.
Langley angling it away from Green, and it was not a very good punt. Out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Sports coverage of NASDAQ College Football will continue after a word from your local station.
For college football.
You know, the only way to eat Hardee's new Big West Bacon Cheeseburger is with total nutrition. That way you can appreciate all the things that make it so great. Like two big beef patties, three strips of bacon, melting cheese, a ton of barbecue sauce, and a huge steak roll. The Big West Bacon Cheeseburger. Only at Hardee's.
Jogger.
Power Towel and News 12 have joined forces to bring you the best happening in your neighborhood. Weather schools throughout our area, with students using the information in classes daily. And you'll get the latest weather results from your neighborhood on New 12.
You can see our first unit network discovery. PowerTel, the first launch for digital wireless TS service in Augusta and Aiken. And together, we're launching Neighborhood Internet, the weather where you are.
Baby, come on. I'm sorry. We'll never go there again.
Go to Amoco. We'll get some ultimate.
You're watching Channel 12, the news station.
Bulldogs lead 7-0 here in Jacksonville, and Florida team doctor Pete Indelicato told me today that Terry Jackson, who tore his ACL in the Kentucky game, actually had his ligament replaced by a ligament from a cadaver. More in a moment.
It's Jamie Richardson with the catch and run, and he's to the 44-yard line, checked by Kurt. A gain of 22. Florida trying to capitalize on the short punt by Langley. Here's Michelle.
Well, that procedure has minimal risk, but can actually help an athlete recover in a shorter period of time. In fact, Jackson started running this week. I talked to him. He told me that physically he'd probably be ready to play by bowl time. One more year of eligibility, guys, and may not want to risk all of next season. One game this season. Back to you.
Well, I think that guy is one of the top players in the country. I've observed for 2 years. He's a fabulous athlete. He helped over so many different ways.
McLean down. They just did get the play off, and it broke in play. Well, they weren't comfortable with the line of scrimmage, and Johnson went down for a loss back to the 47-yard line.
Well, it's hard to know whether Fred went their way or Doug Johnson, but one of them certainly did. Johnson was audible, trying to change the play, and it just didn't work out.
Not an impressive start for the Florida Gators. You mentioned Steve Spurrier, Adjutant's offense. Despite the fact that they're fourth in the nation in scoring offense coming in at just under 42 per game. They put a pile of points on Michigan. 82 to drive that average up. On second and long, chase from the pocket, Johnson. Throws on the run, and it is incomplete. Another catchable ball dropped by a Gator. This time, Eugene McCaslin had it clang off his hands and fall to the ground. Kirby Smart of the coverage, but McCaslin was open.
Florida just has had some real troubles with the offensive line. As you mentioned, Sean, they've just not been comfortable all season long. And the Georgia defensive line is aggressive. They run a little twist stunt. They flush Johnson out of the pocket. Johnson had some initial time to throw, but when you're running for your life and you don't get your feet planted, it's harder to play well. He hit this Gator right smack in the hands. Should have been a reception.
You see that Johnson was angry on the sideline, jabbing a finger at Billy Young, a backup quarterback who helps to signal the play. Johnson on third down and 13th. Oh, incomplete. Jamie Richardson, who dropped a certain touchdown in the first quarter, couldn't catch that one at 25. It would have been a first down. Antonio Cochran put it on Johnson as he delivered.
Jamie Richardson is the guy. Jacquez Green gets double covered or can't get off of Tampa Bailey. Jamie Richardson, number 18, is the guy that got to get open. Ronald Bailey, number 5, on the underneath coverage with some help up above. Brandon Tilbert coming off the pass rush. He's an outside linebacker who rushes in their nickel team.
Robbie Stevenson to punt. Junior from Bradenton. Pick it to Michael Greer. And whistles.
Sean, the early part of this game has got to be to Jimblin's liking, not just because of the score, but the fact that Florida's not been able to get that offense up and down the field with regularity or with speed and quickness. So as a result, Jimblin's game plan is definitely working. His defense is gaining confidence. His offense is moving the ball. They've already put points on the board. They're attacking well. Things are going Georgia's way right now.
And not
Not much has gone the Bulldogs' way in recent years in this rivalry. Georgia's lost the last three meetings between these two teams by a combined score of 151-38. After the delay of game penalty, the extra distance didn't help Robbie Stevenson. He still boomed it in the end zone, a 52-yard punt, a net of 32. Back to Jacksonville in a moment.
I heard about this car that's supposed to be safe for you and your kids, but it's expensive. You probably couldn't afford to have kids and that car at the same time. How about a Chevy Cavalier? It comes with standard anti-lock brakes and next-generation driver and front passenger airbags. So for around $12,800, you can get everything in a car, including kids. Who said that only people who can afford expensive cars should be safe? Car that's easy to own. A Cavalier, genuine Chevrolet. The car's more American.
At My Harley for just $8.
I'm Billy for $12.
Get the lowest commissions possible with Ameritrade. Online for just $8, phone trade for $12, or live broker trade just $18, no matter how many shares.
I can't get to Hilton for $18.
Plus, your first five trades are commission-free when you open an account. Call 1-800-592-6694 or visit our website, Ameritrade, smartest way to trade, period.
I'm Ironhead Hayward. I'm you to challenge it, and I challenge you to try Zestone Body Wash now. I hear you snickering.
But Ironhead, aren't body washes for ladies?
Listen, Junk, this doesn't have any moisturizer.
But Ironhead, what's the thing?
That lather builds the body wash to give you twice the fresh smelling lather of this bar. And it rinses cleaner, so you're cleaner, more refreshed, period.
Zest body wash. Get cleaner, more refreshed.
Get zestfully clean.
Jim, back in New York, coming up on our College Football Today halftime report, Craig and Lou will join me with scores and highlights. Michigan remain undefeated today as its two-way player Charles Woodson took a reverse 33 yards for a touchdown. Now back to the game.
And here in Jacksonville, Georgia leads Florida 7-0. 4.5 minutes played in the second quarter. The only score in this game of the first quarter, a 27-yard touchdown run by Robert Edwards. He lines up behind Mike Bobo as Georgia begins from its own 21st and 10. Patrick pass in trouble. And he is wrapped up and slammed down by Javon Kearse. Back of the 15-yard line.
Jim Donnan trying to run a misdirection play to slow that fast Florida defense down. The start one of the century to Patrick. That's what Javon Kearse for two. He's wonderful. He's such a great open field athlete. He just ate that play up.
Loss of 5, 15. Bobo under pressure. All kinds of strength for Edwards. And he has a first down out of the 31 by Mike Harris. And a first down for the ball.
Interesting to watch Jim Donnan work. First he runs a direction, try to slow the defense down. Then he drops him in with a pass. Those classic ways to take advantage of a real fast defensive team, which Florida has. Rod Edwards kind of hesitates right there. Really didn't take the ball off the field for that extra yardage.
Edwards caught the pass. Was going for the greatest than it did. On first down, Bobo pass deflected and it falls incomplete. Willie Rogers, the senior from Miami, down on the pass.
That's the trouble with a three-step drop once in a while. I like three-step drops, but sometimes defensive linemen get their hands up. They never get near the quarterback, but they jump up and knock those balls down, and that's exactly what happened with Willie Rogers right there.
Seven nothing Georgia, 9.5 remaining till halftime. Second and 10 for the Bulldogs at their own 31. On the draw, Edwards
tripped up for a short gain out to the 33, a pickup of two. Tico Brown, number 33, made the tackle. And we talked about the Florida domination in this rivalry. They've won seven straight, the longest Florida winning streak in this series. Georgia had a seven-game winning streak in this rivalry back in the 1940s. Neither team won eight in a row. Florida trying to accomplish that today. Since 1933, they've played here in Jacksonville, the exception of 94 and 95 when this stadium was being renovated to welcome the Jacksonville Jaguars, and they played on campus sites. Florida has been winning and big in the 90s. That pass on target, Corey Allen, first down, Georgia, out of the 49-yard line. Tico Brown again made the tackle. That's a gain of 16 on the pass to the senior from Riverdale, Georgia. Dwayne Thomas is injured again. He was down earlier, and he's down in the field again. That's a 28-yard line.
You want to credit the Georgia offensive line. They're doing a great job against one of the best offensive lines in the conference. Florida has 35 sacks on the year. 35 sacks. And Georgia offensive line is giving Mike Bobo the time to throw. They've only given up, Georgia's only given up six sacks on the season. So they're doing a great job.
Thomas being ordered off the field.
You know, Sean, going back to the rivalry, I guarantee him on him before the game. He's talking to his football team, and he's saying, hey, guys, I want to be the coach of the team that was 8 years to Florida. Do you guys want to be the players that lose 8 years to Florida? Those kind of motivational things take players to a different level. I've been there. I know I've said it myself, not 8 years maybe, but hey, we don't want to be the team that sets any negative records. Let's be one that sets a positive record.
Two sides don't agree on how many times they played, as you saw on that series note. This is Olandis Gary, dropped for a loss back to the 47. There was a game played between Georgia and a club team representing Florida back in 1904. Georgia won that game. Florida doesn't count it in the series history because they said the University of Florida hadn't even been recognized yet by the Florida State Legislature. So Georgia claims that win and says this is the 76th meeting today, while Florida says this is the 75th anniversary of the rivalry.
I'd have to lean to Florida in that argument. My instinct would say Florida's right. Georgia's stretching the win streak a little bit.
Bono under pressure and sack by Javon Kearse. The team leading will go to 5.5 for the year. That's the second Florida sack today.
Florida isolates Javon Kearse, 42. Isolated on Robert Edwards, 47. Javon Kearse, a wonderful open field athlete who has athleticism galore. He got blocked, got off the ground, and made the big sack.
Dwayne Thomas' shoulder pads off. It's never a good sign. We're told that he has a dislocated. And you can see him grimacing as he took the shoulder pads off, and he is not going to return. Low snap fielded by Bono. Screen intercepted! Willie Cummins down at the 20-yard line. It was intended for Edwards, but too low. And Cummins. The defense and picked it
off. Give the credit to Willie Cohen for the interception, but give the credit for the pressure to Mike Moulton, number 90. He's the guy that accelerates in on the quarterback. Watch him come off the block and then burst towards Mike Bobo. That forces a bad throw. Willie Cohen's on the spot with the interception. A defensive lineman's dream. Get the football in your hands.
His first of the season, as you might expect. Great field position for Florida. The 23, they're going for the end zone, and it is incomplete. Green had it for a moment, but never had possession. Champ Bailey and Jeff Harris had the coverage, and that's another ball in the end zone that might have been caught for a Florida touchdown.
When you got Jaquez Green out wide, you got a lot of things to do to the Georgia defense. Florida is as good as anyone in the country at running the fade route up the sideline. They do a wonderful job of giving themselves room to fade on the ball. Jaquez Green goes outside the defensive back, question is, did he have a control of the ball? And he was bobbling the ball, the official right there on the spot.
Florida fans are blowing his old screen, but didn't seem that Green argued, and it did not appear that he ever completely had possession of this football. Now that's still, that's not a completion.
Number four, Champ Bailey came over, made a great play over the top, and actually knocked the ball loose.
Five wide receivers spreading the field. The pass caught underneath by Darryl Jackson, the true freshman from Tampa. Just fourth catch of the season. And Greg Bright made the tackle just inside the 19, a short gain on the play.
If Florida's not throwing a close to the post, hands down the field, DB's outside. Go inside on the post. If the DB's inside, he'll go post and then post corner. That's how Florida loves to attack.
Johnson going toward the goal line, incomplete. The ball underthrown and intended for Nafis Kareem. And it'll be fourth down at about six. And the field goal team is coming on for Steve Spurrier.
Where Florida's really getting pressure out of their offensive line is up the middle. The inside players for the Georgia defense are getting pressure on that line.
Collins Cooper hasn't tried many this season. Three out of five. This is a 36-yard try from the right hash mark. Billy Young is the holder, and that kick is good for the junior from Jacksonville. Cooper was fired up about getting in this stadium. He's a huge Jaguar fan. And Florida's on the board.
Meet Sean Graham, veteran stuntman. This is how he lives. This drives. What else would drive? Chevy S10. Like rock.
Two tickets, $28. Two hot dogs, two popcorns, and two sodas, $18. One autographed baseball, $45. Real conversation with 11-year-old son. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Except that all over, even major ballparks.
Welcome to Packer Bell Service and Support. How can I help you?
Hi, it's Kelly, Major.
And who's that I hear?
Jane's a big cranky. Listen, I'm having trouble with my computer.
Okay, well, one problem at a time. Put Jamie on.
At Packer Bell Service and Support, we can solve just about any problem. Packard Bell, the computer the world comes home to. Featuring the Intel Pentium 2 processor.
Jim Donnan said we really can't make mistakes against a team like Florida. His quarterback's thrown three interceptions today, but Florida still just has the 3 points on the board.
And I think that's the key, Sean. When you talk about turnovers, it's points off of turnovers. Getting turnovers don't do you that much good if you don't get points off.
Good kick by Robbie Stevenson, a yard into the end zone. Hines Ward following a group of blockers. And he's close to the 20. And that's where Georgia will start this possession. Last week we asked you who you thought was college football's greatest defensive lineman of all time. These nominees: Leroy Selman, Bubba Smith, Ross Brown, Green, and Randy White. Now the results of the CBS Sportsline all-time greats poll. Bubba Smith the winner.
I played against Bubba Smith in the 1966 Rose Bowl. I was at UCLA. Bubba Smith was at Michigan. They were the national champ. They were the number one in the country. Came in. Bruins upset him. 14-12 in that game. And
you do.
Bubba, I didn't play against Bubba right over. He was playing. So was I, thank goodness.
Robert Edwards. Pull out to the 22. Mike Harris and Devon Kearse made the tackle.
Bubba Smith and myself, Sean, would be a bad matchup for the Bruins. Trust me.
Well, Georgia came in to today's game with five turnovers.
fewest in the nation. We've turned it over three times today. All interceptions thrown by Bobo.
If that continues, Jim Donnan may go to Hines Ward and go with more of an option package and try to just run the ball and play defense and hang in there if the turnovers continue.
As it's helped the Bulldog cause that Johnson could have thrown two INTs. Bobo going deep, single coverage out there. Corey Allen has it. And he's thrown down by Fred Weary at the 19. That was a terrific throw by Bobo to Allen, who has up on Weary.
And Mike Bobo must have hurt us. You talk about the fade route. Corey Allen lines up, gives himself plenty of room from the sideline so he can go outside. You don't see Fred Weary, number 24 from Florida, get beat very often, but it is a tremendous throw by Mike Bobo. He put air underneath the ball, and Allen ran underneath it for the huge play.
59-yard gain. Back to the run with Edwards running right. He cuts inside through a big hole. Edwards inside the five with a first down at the two.
Chris Perry, number seven, the right tackle of Georgia, made a great block. Georgia is attacking Florida to the open end side, not to the tight end side, but to the open end side with this week. Unusual. It's
Florida. No play. The officials blowing the way for a sack. It was a gator running to get off the field. Elijah Williams very late.
Timeout.
Racing to the sideline, and Florida had to use a timeout. First goal from the three for Georgia when we come back.
My name is Anda Andre, Director of Design for Ian Schrager Hotels. I direct the creative effort of building all the hotels.
We are our worst competition, so we just work with ourselves. The thing, as long as you have to be competitive in the world you are living, thing that helps, you should get.
Georgia fans making the noise in Jacksonville at the moment. The Dogs lead by four, and they have first and goal. We're live at Altel Stadium for the Gator Bowl in Jacksonville. We're looking for first win over since 1989. It's first win against the top 10 opponent since 1991. Trying to prove that the Georgia program is back and for real, and a win today would accomplish that. They're 6-1, but they really don't have a win you can hang your hat on. Quickly to the line, Bobo brings the Bulldogs. Edwards following Selma Calloway, and he's stacked up at the two. Perhaps just inside the two, Javon Kirsch and Fred Weary made the tackle.
Boy, it looked initially like this play was going to get into the end zone. They had the ball in Robert Edwards' hand. He's a great back, but 42, Javon Kirsch. He, along with Fred Weary, who ran across the screen, 24, they come up and make a picture-perfect team tackle there for the no gain.
Georgia has done well in the red zone, scoring touchdowns 48% of the time. Actually, they haven't done as well. The national average is higher than their average. And it's taking a long time on the hole here. The officials now winding the clock.
Georgia players were asking the crowd in that end of the end zone to be quiet so they could hear the snap. Now, those are Georgia fans. You got to be able to hear.
Edwards again up and over. That's a tough play to run from the two. That requires a long leap. Edwards didn't get there. He got a yard to the one, so he picked up 1 yard on each of the first two plays since the first and goal of the three.
Reggie McGrew, 92, get great penetration right in there. Penetrates that line, forces Woods to go up early. It's not a good play. As you mentioned, John, it's a long way to lead. Robert Edwards would have been better by his on the ground and pounded in there.
Bobo, play action. Pass batted down. Darrell Owens, the reserve linebacker, playing because of the injuries.
effort at linebacker today by Furtick. Made the big play. Now Jim Donovan with a big call on fourth and goal to one.
Jim Donovan tried to slip the fullback out of the backfield on a play-action pass. The Florida defense runs. The tight end is covered. It's really just excellent defense by Florida all the way across the board.
Timeout, Georgia. Jim Donovan ponders the big decision.
Be active, be cool, but beware. Use an ordinary stick antiperspirant, you get flaky white stuff. Until now. Gillette introduces Clear Stick. It's clear, so it can't leave a white residue. And it glides on smooth and dry for maximum strength stick protection. No stick protects you better against odor and wetness. So don't get the white stuff. Get the clear advantage. Gillette Clear Stick. Or try cool, refreshing clear gel.
Coach for the Georgia Bulldogs, Jim Donovan. You've lost seven in a row in this rivalry. You have it on the one-yard line. Four down and goal. Field goal.
I think there's always thoughts of a field goal because that's a concern play. But Jim Donovan, he knows he's playing against Florida's offense. You want points. You want momentum. And you want your players to believe you believe.
Right.
That's the key.
They've
got to believe that you believe. Do you go for it?
Fourth and goal from the one. Fourth and goal three. Couple of rings. Got a into pass. Callaway and Edwards the backfield. Edwards! Down!
The Florida defense got knocked off the ball by the Georgia offensive line, and Robert Edwards go up and over. It's a great leap by Edwards. Number 47 takes it into the end zone. The play failed two plays earlier, but this time successful.
That's Langley. Takes over half Hines, and Langley kicked the extra point. Second rushing touchdown of the game for Edwards, and on fourth down and goal from the one, Georgia gets the TD. The gamble paid off for Jim Donovan and his Dogs in a big surprise lead by 11.
You feel like brushing your teeth?
Is this a trick question?
We can't just clean the front of things.
Why not? That's all you see.
The dentist told Mommy problems can start where we can't see.
Introducing the Crest Multi-Clean Toothbrush. It not only cleans deep between teeth, its cup-shaped design surrounds and helps clean all around every tooth, even places you can't see.
Mom, you don't miss things.
New Crest Multi-Clean. Fits between to get teeth clean.
Well, as you saw in the pregame show, a couple members of our esteemed studio panel picked Florida to go to the Orange Bowl. We wonder if they're changing their picks. We'll find out at halftime. The halftime report with Jim, Craig, and Lou coming up. Long way to go in this one. Of course, Florida, one of the most explosive teams in the country. Right now, they're in a 11-point hole. Mark Johnson kicks off for the Dogs. Squibs it downfield again. Picked up by Eugene McCaslin. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line. 12 yards on the return for McCaslin. Dustin Lucky made a tackle for Georgia. Two touchdowns for Eddie.
When you kick off like Sean, you know, a lot of people, the other you get pretty good field position. The ball's at the 35, but what you do generally in the game, we're back. And Georgia philosophy today, don't give up the big play. Make for it, work for everything they get.
Doug Johnson throws downfield first. Nice head behind the face Kareem, but the Georgia native made the reception for a pickup of 16 out to the field. Kareem is from Marietta, Georgia, near Atlanta.
Great adjustment by Kareem on that ball. That ball was well thrown behind him. He did a very athletic move, spun around, caught it, and it was thrown like a shot out of Johnson's hand.
Johnson throws near side. Eugene McCaslin the catch. He puts his head down and pushes the play to the 42-yard line. Rontus Grant and Ronald Bailey made the tackle. McCaslin's missed the last two games. He's been bothered by a left knee injury. Back in action today.
Florida's made a change in the offensive line. They take has a hamstring. They moved him to right tackle, trying to shore up that line.
Fred Taylor is loose, and he's tackled by Glenn Ford. Florida moving quickly, and they're down to the 21-yard line. They're gaining a 12. 2.5 minutes left in the half. Bulldogs lead by 11.
Eugene McCaslin makes a nice block on this particular play. Fred Taylor just runs the draw. The fullback leads him through, makes an excellent block on the linebacker. And Fred Taylor's a dangerous player in the open field. He's got great vision and cutting ability.
First and 10, pass caught. Jamie Richardson back from 24, but they'll give him forward progress to that spot. Greg Bright made a hit on Richardson, who's had a couple of key drops here in the first half.
John, as a coach, you always talk to your team about how you respond to adversity. Florida is back against the adversity now.
Timeout, Florida.
Well, folks, Doug is the man. Doug took this place global. Doug made commitments around the world. Doug convinced me to risk it all. It was Doug who shipped everything with some company I never screwed the whole thing up. And that's why Doug is locked up in the closet.
Hello.
You okay in there, buddy?
Next time, make it FedEx, the most reliable express company there is.
Can I come out now?
No, Doug. I'm not finished singing your praises.
We have some of Hollywood's hottest stuntmen to try Degree.
What's body heat activated?
As your body heat rises, Degree releases extra protection when you need it most.
I heated up, and it cooled me down.
I was on fire, and I was dry.
Body heat activated Degree. Your body heat turns it on.
Is your dandruff sending signals? Selsun Power. Docs recommend Selsun Boom number one. So don't send the wrong signals. Get Selsun Power.
Well, Christopher Columbus is a little late in arriving here at Alltel Stadium, but that's going to be the second half. The Budweiser Brand Eye in the Sky Camera proud to provide you these live shots. 1,000 feet above Alltel Stadium. Second down and three. Florida, your timeout. Johnson. For a big loss back to the 35 by Marcus Stroud. First time Johnson's been sacked today.
It's the first time he's been sacked, Sean, but the Georgia defensive line has put a lot of heat on him, and Florida's going to go with an offense here. But the line of Georgia has been able to put pressure on him that has disrupted him.
Brandon Miller to the first. First hit, but then it was Stroud who wrapped him up and down. Third and 13. Johnson in trouble again. Johnson all the way back at the end line, running away from Stroud. Now he's going to try to run up now. At the 25-yard line, chased out by Antonio Cochran. He's about 3 yards, nearly five, shy of the first down. And it'll be fourth down and 4.5. Brandon Miller and Derek Byrd put the pressure on Johnson. Nearly had another sack.
The Florida line's having trouble. Watch 74, Zach DeZalis. He's having a difficult time with the Georgia front on that particular play. Johnson does a great job fighting to get the ball back up to the line of scrimmage.
Florida's going for it. It'll be about a 43-yard field goal. Five wide receivers on fourth and five. Johnson over the middle, and it is incomplete. Jamie Richardson hit immediately by Greg Bright, and Richardson couldn't hold it. It would have been very close to a first down, and Georgia takes over on downs.
It's a great call by the Florida offense. They run a little underneath route, but the Georgia defense, he's going to run underneath and just try to get the first down. Greg Bright, 45, comes up with one of those picture tackles, stops the player's momentum short of the first. That's the way you pass a linebacker. It's Joe Kynes, he's loving it as that defensive coordinator. George, he loves it. Look at him.
And he loves this team. He told us last week it's the best group of players that he's been around in 33 years. And says they've had one bad practice the whole year. Jim Dunham doesn't want to make a mistake that Kentucky made against him last week when Kentucky got a little greedy in the first half. Georgia picked one off and ran it in. Now it changed the complexion of that game. He'll be very happy with an 11-point lead over the sixth-ranked Gators at halftime.
Well, and you're backed up. It's really a good move. A lot of times fans don't appreciate it or agree with it. But, hey, you're ahead. You were an underdog. You're like you say, you're 11 points. Things are going well. Don't make a mistake in this area of the field.
Oh, letting the clock run down. And they should not have to snap it again. They do not. Been a long time since the Bulldogs had a lead on the Gators at the break. 1988, the last time it happened. 1989, the last time they defeated Florida. Credit Jim Donnan. He coached a terrific first half. This team well prepared. Here's Michelle.
Coach, three first half points, very uncharacteristic. What will it take to get this offense going?
Georgia's just beating us. That's all you can say. We can't score right now. Maybe we can later. We'll try.
Thanks, Coach.
That is the end of the first half with the score. Georgia 14, Florida 3. Jim Nantrames and Lou Holtz will be along with college football today right after the third from your local station.
For college football action, the address CBS. Welcome home. Now's the time to celebrate savings at Winn-Dixie's unbelievable buy one, get one free sale. Hurry into Winn-Dixie and stock up with terrific buy one, get one free savings throughout the store. Look for items like Popeye's bacon, Spam luncheon meat, and Oscar Mayer bologna. All buy one, get one free. Plus, get Captain Crunch.
Made some mistakes on offense, but our defense likes out. They've dropped a couple passes, but, you know, I'm real pleased with the score. You know, we've taken a couple chances and they work, but it's going to be a great second half.
Indeed, if a team can come back, it's Florida. What can we going into the second half?
We just got to make them earn everything and get good field position, and hopefully our offense is going to play better.
Coach, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Sean?
We'll return to Jacksonville with the second half kickoff. Beginning to set on North Florida. Way to go in this one. Second half ready to begin. Georgia with an 11-point lead, and Mark Johnson kicks off for the Bulldogs. Bo Carroll from the two. The true freshman from Norristown, Pennsylvania. Trying to cut back at the 30, and he goes down there. A 28-yard kickoff return. Dustin Lucky made the tackle. During the week, Terry, Jim Donnan said, if you're going to beat Florida, you need to play well, but you also need to have a little bit of help from Florida, as LSU did when it beat the Gators.
Well, there's no question Florida's turned the ball over a little bit to Georgia. The line of Georgia, the defensive line, has pressured Johnson. How well they play this second half is going to be critical.
Interception's a big part of the first half. Georgia picked off two Doug Johnson passes. Johnson also had a couple dropped, one in the end zone. Brindley's at quarterback for Florida to begin the second half. Doug Johnson after those two INTs in the first half with only 3 points on the board for the game has been yanked. And here's Brindley's, who came off the bench in place of Jesse Palmer 2 weeks ago at Auburn and led the Gators to victory.
You know, Steve Spurrier said during the week, if the ball gets turned over too much, if I'm not police, I'm not going to hesitate. He felt like he waited too long at LSU to pull his quarterback.
Dice, a senior, throws, and it is caught for a first down. Kirby Smart delivered the hit on Jacquez Green. Brindice is on target. That's a gain of 18. Brindice came as a walk-on, a transfer from the Division II Wingate College in North Carolina back in 1992.
Runs an inside route. There's not a lot of room between the defenders there. Does a great job of hanging on this ball after Kirby Smart really loads on it.
Fiddler with McCaslin, Lundell, Lachette. Brindice confidently over the middle, and it is almost intercepted. The pass a little high for McCaslin
And then Champ Bailey had his fingertips on what would have been his second interception of the ball game.
Sean, where the Florida team is trying to adjust is in the offensive line. Zach Piller, who had been a left tackle, is now playing right tackle. He's got a bad hamstring. They've got to get their quarterback protected. They need more protected. Cheston Blackshear, number 77, is now at right guard. He was a starter, demoted a few weeks ago. Now he's back starting.
A handoff to Taylor across midfield. First down and more. Fred Taylor all the way to the 37-yard line where Kirby Smart made the stop. 18 yards on the gain for the senior from Belgrade, Florida, Fred Taylor.
Just talked about the new line, and you can watch 69. The right tackles, Zach Piller, he just takes his man to the inside, crushes him downside, which enables Taylor to see the daylight and run to the open seam. Those adjustments in the Florida line may be very, very critical as this game progresses.
Florida on the move with the new quarterback at the helm, Bryn Dice. Wide receiver, Carroll lined up as a wide out, tackled along the near sideline by Marlos Leroy at the 33-yard line. That's a gain of five. The halftime stitch. Favorite Georgia time of possession. Also in favor of the Bulldogs that have the edge in virtually every category.
I just don't think very often that Florida would have 144 yards of total offense. It's a characteristic. But their line, quite frankly, has been whipped today by the Georgia defense thus far.
Tinkering with that offensive line, and they're still searching for the right combination. Right at the top of the screen, appear to be confused. Bryn Dice just did the playoff. Bryn Dice throws, and it is almost picked off. And perhaps that was a product of the confusion. Jacquez Green pulled up at about the 20. The pass was well off the mark, and Champ Bailey again got fingertips on the ball, but no INT.
Now, Jacquez Green and Travis McGriff didn't hear the check, but Jacquez Green, he just slips. He ran down the field. He's going to run an inside route. His legs gave out right there, and that's why the ball didn't appear to be well thrown. See, McGriff didn't get the check off. He couldn't hear and couldn't understand what the check was.
Third down and five. The Gators just 2 out of 7 on third down today. They trail by 11. First possession of the third quarter. Bryn Dice incomplete. The ball thrown well behind Jacquez Green. Again, Bailey at tight coverage. And Bryn Dice on the drive, 2 out of 5 for 20 yards. He didn't have spectacular numbers against Auburn, 5 for 11 for 69 yards, but he did lead them to a victory.
And Noah Bryn Dice in the pocket is going to get slammed by Brandon Miller, 51, who puts an outstanding pass rush, bull rush move on. Really a great rush that disrupts the throwing tempo.
Gators will go for it on fourth down, it appears. Fourth and five of the Georgia 33. Bryn Dice, with the play clock running down, forced to use the timeout. That really hurt the Gators later. Still Georgia by 11 early in the third quarter in Jacksonville. Here comes a very big play with Florida trying to turn the momentum in its favor and Georgia trying to keep things going its way. Fourth and five for Florida. At the Georgia 33, Bryn Dice deep down the middle and caught! Down to the one goes Jamie Richardson.
Richardson lines up as the inside receiver, and he just runs straight down the field. And the free safety, Kirby Smart, tries to come over and make the play. He's just a little bit late. It's a beautiful, beautiful throw, Noah Bryn Dice. Those are hard seams to hit down the middle of that defense like that.
On fourth and five, they got 32. Now Taylor driving to the goal line. No signal. He did not get in. Greg Bright stood him up right at the stripe. And it'll be second and goal for the Gators. Taylor wound up losing his helmet.
Fred Taylor's the kind of back that you want to give him the ball again because he's a powerful back. He just gets met at the line of scrimmage beautifully by Greg Bright. Greg Bright, of course, is the leader in solo tackles in the history of the University of Georgia.
Second and goal, Bryn Dice. on the quarterback sneak. Touchdown! Didn't get by much, but he got it. First rushing touchdown of the season for Brindis. And it's 14-9. I thought Steve Spurrier might go for two to get within a field goal, but this early he just wants to get the 1 point, make it a four-point game.
You have to give Noah Brindis credit and Steve Spurrier. He makes a critical quarterback change coming out of half. What you want to do is, whatever you do when you change quarterbacks, you love to see your offense move. And sure enough, the Florida offense got moved behind Brindis.
Cooper adds the extra point. Out of the hole to Billy Young. An impressive 10-play drive capped by this from Brindis.
The senior quarterback just fought his way into the end zone.
It's a four-point game in Jacksonville.
Football on CBS is sponsored by the NASDAQ Stock Market. Selsun Blue, doctors recommend it number one for dandruff. Selsun Blue. And by Microsoft, where do you want to go today?
Georgia gets the ball for the first time in the second half after the kickoff from Robbie Stevenson. It'll be a big possession for Georgia. The Gators with light in their step after the impressive drive. Champ Bailey from just inside the five started stumbling near the 20, went down to the 24-yard line. Let's get an update on this injured Florida defense from Michelle.
Yeah, Sean, here is the update. All three starters either ill or injured. Johnny Rutledge, who got sick on the sidelines earlier, took two bags of IV fluid during halftime. He should be fine. As we told you earlier, Dwayne Thomas is out with a dislocated shoulder, and we're now told that Mike Peterson also done for the day with that sprained right knee he suffered in the first half. Sean?
And Keith Kelsey ordinarily sees a lot of action. Linebacker has been seen today. He bruised a shoulder during the week in practice. Gator fans into it now. Bobo with time. Going deep, and it is incomplete. He was looking for Patrick Pass. And Pass was well covered by Mike Harris. Next Saturday, our college football coverage begins with College Football Today at 3 time with Jim Craig and Lou, then Regional Bridge. Some of you will see LSU against Alabama at 3:30, while others see a battle from the Big East between Boston College and Syracuse. That's next Saturday with the pregame show. It's 3 o'clock NASDAQ College Football on CBS Sports. Second and 10. Bobo to the air again, near side, caught. Hines Ward very close to a first down. Out of the 34, Elijah Williams had the coverage.
Hines Ward did an outstanding job making like he was going deep. Hines Ward went deep and then all of a sudden broke the route out to an out position, and Mike Bobo throws a well-timed ball. It's there, and Hines Ward catches it in his hands. He can play so many positions. This guy really is Mr. Versatility. He's a dangerous player on the field.
And as he says, he's only going to get better at wide receiver because he's played there for just two seasons. Feels he is not an accomplished receiver yet.
I like him because he's tough.
Edwards, no gain on first and 10. Buck Gurley, number 99, got a hand on him, and Tony George came up from the secondary. Gurley's a redshirt freshman from Tallahassee. Robert Edwards hasn't done much up the middle today.
Oh, but Robert Edwards has given Georgia some balance. It's made the Florida defense play honest, which is what you really want when you play like Georgia plays. Their philosophy is balance. That's what they strive for, and they're getting some of it today.
14 Georgia. The Bulldogs led 14-3 at the half. The Gators scored on their first possession of this half. Now it's the Bulldogs with the ball. Hines Ward, the intended target. The pass is incomplete. Elijah Williams running with him. And it'll be third down and 10 for the Dogs.
Hines Ward tries to run a post corner. He acted like he's going down the middle of the field, and all of a sudden he takes it to the outside. But Elijah Williams Williams, 25, the converted offensive player playing cornerback. He's right in his hip pocket. A great job defense. No interference. Just outstanding play by Florida.
Not a great day for Bobo, but his team has the lead. Bobo asked for a timeout. They were going to send Bobo out wide and line up Ward at quarterback again. The Bulldogs were confused. Each team has burned a timeout in the third. Third down and 10 for Georgia. After the Bulldogs line up, each team has used one here in the third quarter. Dogs at their own 34, leading by 4 points. Bobo remained at quarterback. His pass is well short of a first down to Corey Allen. He was tackled immediately by Fred Weary with help from Tony George. And the Dogs will be forced to punt.
Awfully good defense that series by the Florida Gators. That defense has risen its head now. Mike Bobo and the Georgia Bulldogs are going to have to go to work next time they get the ball.
Dax Langley is the punter, the senior from Conyers, Georgia. Nose up spiral, not a long punt, and handled by Jacquez Green at the 31-yard line. A 31-yard punt. Today's NASDAQ Scholar Athlete of the Game is John Ixnaitis of Florida. NASDAQ's commitment to the investment in our future is shown today by donating $1,000 to the Florida General Scholarship Fund. He's a three-time All SEC academic selection with a 3.32 grade point average. They have not started much better for Florida. Touchdown on the opening drive. Three plays, actually one for Georgia, and then a punt for the Bulldogs. And the offense back on the field for the Gators. Fred Taylor dragging a tackle out to the 34. Marlis Leroy made the tackle, junior from Albany, Georgia, making the play on Taylor.
You know, I think it's interesting, Sean, how Steve Spurrier is not afraid to shuffle quarterbacks. But you have to really hesitate and think about it when you're the head coach, when you yank a quarterback, because it undermines their confidence a little bit. There's no question about that. You have to worry about Doug Johnson. You also have to worry about Noah Brandeis and Jesse Palmer. You've got a lot going on as a head coach when you're making these decisions.
To the 44, that's a first down. Antonio Cochran made the tackle. There's Jim Nance.
Well, fellas, this is when a lot of people won't believe Louisiana Tech, and it doesn't even have Terry Bradshaw at quarterback. It's Tim Rattay, well over 300 yards passing. Nation's leading receiver, Troy Edwards, takes it 49 yards. 5 minutes to go. Bama's down 26-13. Back to Sean and Terry.
Wow, what a day. That, of course, is not a conference game, but Auburn has lost. Mississippi State, now Alabama trailing. There's another first down for Florida. Brandeis on target to Jamie Richardson, and Glenn Ford made the tackle 25 yards on that pass play.
Sometimes senior quarterbacks come alive. They're on the bench a long time. I know at UCLA, I had Rick Neuheisel as a senior come alive. David Norrie, both of them took us to championship-type years, and all of a sudden, Noah Brandeis, he's the quarterback on the hot seat at Florida, but he's responding. You've got to be impressed with what this senior did at Auburn and now here against Georgia.
In his fourth year in the program as a transfer, as a walk-on, as we mentioned. Fred Taylor inside the 20. First down. Out of the 10-yard line. Kirby Smart and Jeff Harris made the tackle for the wilting Georgia defense. 18 yards on the run for Taylor.
Bo Collins, the big left tackle, along with Ryan Kalick, the guard. These two guys right there, they're the ones that open the hole on the draw. And sure enough, when you're in doubt, give the ball to Fred Taylor, 21, and he usually does something good with it. That's what Steve Spurrier told us.
He has 75 yards rushing on 15 carries. As they fake the reverse, Taylor gets the tackle. Kirk Martin runs him out at the 5. It will be second down from the 5. They can get another first down near the 1-yard line. 14-10.
Georgia has the lead, but it is a tenuous advantage for the Bulldogs.
Fred Taylor that time just ran right over the top of Whit Ford, number seven, one of the secondary players, came up for Georgia to try to make the play, and Fred Taylor just whacked him and kept on moving.
Taylor again up the middle. Stopped short of the first down and the goal line by Antonio Cochran. He's down at the three. They'll need three for the touchdown, two for a first down, with third down upcoming.
Sean, I'm going to go back to what I said earlier about the changes in the offensive line for Florida. Number 77, Cheston Blackshear. He was the starter at right guard, got demoted. Now he's played this entire half at right guard. Mo Collins, who shifted over from right tackle to left tackle. Zach Piller on the right side. Those are their best players, but Piller's injury has really messed them up.
Timeout called by Florida. The line has had its problems, and you wonder if all the tinkering Steve Spurrier has done contributes to those problems. Back in a moment.
The University of Georgia has assembled a world-class teaching and research faculty on a campus with an established tradition of excellence. Hello, I'm Michael Adams. As president of America's first chartered state university, I'm committed to moving this institution to even greater levels of achievement. The future of our nation begins with the education of our youth. Please join me as we prepare the University of Georgia for another great century service.
Sean McDonough with Terry Donahue and Michelle Tafoya back at sold out Allstate Stadium in Jacksonville, Florida. On the first possession of the second half, went 70 yards for a score. This drive, they've marked 66. And they're looking at third down, two for a first down, three for a touchdown as the Gators try to take the lead for the first time today. Noah Brindise wants to be a college football coach. That's the reason why he decided to walk on at Florida to learn Steve Spurrier. Hand off to the fullback, right? Crazier to the goal line. Touchdown!
In the first half, Georgia was winning the battle up front with their defensive line against Florida's offensive line. But in this half, it's a different story. That's a powerful push by the Florida offensive line. And Steve Spurrier knows he's got the right combination going right now with Noah Brindise at quarterback and that reworked offensive line.
Collins Cooper's right down the middle with the extra point. First touchdown rushing of the season for Frazier, and Florida leads for the first time today.
The Montana Grizzlies visiting the Delaware Blue Hens in a classic 1AA matchup. The Blue Hen safety, he cuts across. He's got an interception. He's at the 40, the 45, the 50, the 47, 45, and 5/8, 316, and 227. Okay, TV timeout.
What was an 11-point lead for Georgia at halftime has quickly become a 3-point advantage for Florida. Just more than midway through the third quarter. Robbie Stevenson puts the foot to it. Champ Bailey from the three. And he's tripped up at the 22-yard line. Tackled by Taurus Ross, a reserve tight end. Welcome home to America's Night of Television tonight on CBS. Tune in to Dr. Quinn, Medicine Woman, Early Edition, and Walker, Texas Ranger. All tonight on CBS.
this afternoon and this evening on CBS hasn't been too shabby either. What a ball game this has been. Georgia, three-touchdown underdog. Had an 11-point lead at halftime, but Florida, with a new quarterback at the helm, has roared to two touchdowns and two possessions here in the third quarter. Robert Edwards trying to get outside, following the block of Chris Terry. He gets nothing. Perhaps a yard, but that's it. Johnny Rutledge made the tackle.
It's awfully hard to run misdirection type plays against the Florida defense. They're so quick to diagnose the play and then so fast to run to the ball. Jim Donnan said he was going to run a couple of them today. That was one of them. He ran one or two earlier in the first half. You won't see it a lot, though, because it's not going to be effective against this defense. I think Jim Donnan needs to come back and run the weak side open end sweep, which really hurt Florida in the first half of the game, and I haven't seen it in the second half yet.
He sends three wide receivers to the right. Underneath to Hines Ward, tackled by Elijah Williams. Stop Ward short of a first down. Let's get another update on the Alabama ball game from Jim Nance.
Well, let's not give up on the Crimson Tide just yet at Bryant Denny Stadium, because Freddie Kitchens finds Chad Goss, and then the Louisiana Tech secondary kind of gets lost. Goss will pick his way to the end zone, 26-20. Decides 3 minutes to go. Tech just fumbled, but it recovered and has the football. Let's go back to Sean and Terry.
Wow, that Jim Nance, he loves those exciting finishes. My old partner.
Hines Ward carries for the first down.
Boy, Sean, I love the way that Hines Ward can do so many things. Here they push up, he runs the option play, and he attacks the defense. This guy is a dangerous runner. He's got vision. And, you know, in a bowl game a couple years ago as a quarterback, he threw for 400 yards in the Peach Bowl.
That was a bowl game record for the Peach Bowl in 95. In a loss to Virginia, threw for 413 yards.
That's a bunch of yards against anybody, particularly a good Virginia team.
And he's still at quarterback. We expected to see an option look out of this today, and there it is. Edwards runs out of bounds. A gain on first down out to the 36.
I'm sure that Jim Donnan looked at the LSU Florida film and said, hey, LSU attacked that defense with some option plays. Not all, but some, and it was effective for him. It's a nice change of pace against this Florida defense. I think this is great strategy. Mike Bobo's not having a great day. Get him out, let him rest a little bit, get him settled down. Go ahead with your guy, Hines, and put Bobo back in.
And he is back in now on second down. Second and eight. Under 5 minutes remaining, third quarter. Florida leads by three. Great deal of time for Bobo. The pass caught by the tight end, Larry Brown. He has a first down to the 49-yard line. Fred Weary chopped him down. Brown, a junior from Decatur, Georgia, with a gain of 14.
Just runs a drag route. He just drags across the formation, but credit the Georgia offensive line. Mike Bobo had plenty of time to get his feet planted, stay on his rhythm and timing. That's what the quarterback needs to be effective. He knows it. That was great protection and well-executed play by Mike Bobo.
Certainly helps Georgia after the momentum shift to have Bobo a senior quarterback, Edwards a senior running back, Ward their best receiver a senior. Pass is on target to Torrey Allen. He's pulled down by Fred Weary, but it's another first down for the Bulldogs. The 35 of Florida. 15 on the pass to Corey Allen.
Corey Allen's had a good day-to-day blocking as a wide receiver, and also on this reception, he kind of pushes off a little bit. Fred Weary has his hand on him. He had his hand on him from the very start, but Corey Allen wasn't going to take that. He shoved him off, and no call, so it's a good play.
On first and 10, Edwards tripped up. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Willie Cohens, who had an interception in the first half, broke through the offensive line and got Edwards around the legs.
That was the play I mentioned a few moments ago, but that Georgia hadn't shown in the second half. The toss sweep to the open end side. Robert Edwards just turned it up a little little bit too early. And on this particular time, that's Stinchcomb, the left tackle, didn't really get his man knocked off the ball. Good penetration by the Florida defense.
Edwards goes in motion. Florida starts at the number two in the nation, rushing defense. George has had a decent day, not spectacular running the ball. That's a pass by Hines Ward. Short of first down, it seems, at the 26, short by about a yard. It'll be third down and one. .245 remaining, third quarter. Mike Bobo, the son of a coach. His father, George, was his high school coach in Thomasville, Georgia. Bounces across the 25 to get the first down by about a yard, following the blocks of the fullback, Selma Calloway.
Boy, that's a nice run by Robert Edwards, the fullback. Selma Calloway actually misses the block. But Edwards, he's a powerful guy. He's a 200-plus pound running back, and he's healthy for the first time all season long. And you can watch him take the ball. He'll spin. He gets hit, spins around, keeps his momentum moving forward, and gets the pads down and picks up the first down.
Impressive drive for Georgia. This is the 10th play. First and 10. Bobo throws. Caught. Corey Allen down at the one. Tackled by Fred Weary.
Like he was running a streak against Fred Weary. He acts like he's going outside, then he breaks it off inside with a quick post move. He turned Weary around. The ball is well thrown. Corey Allen's had a big day, a lot of blocks and reception.
On first and goal, Edwards. Touchdown! And Georgia goes back on top.
Once again, it's a great vertical jump, and the offensive line denied the Florida defense penetration.
Dax Langley will try the extra point out of the hole. Drew Monick. Take a 4-point lead, and it is good.
What's your drive, Sean? What a drive.
Hope to have seniors in a pressure-packed situation, and the seniors delivered on that drive from Hawks.
Lessons young people learn from a coach are important throughout their lives. Things like character, self-discipline, motivation, and teamwork. A coach is a mentor. But you don't have to be in sports to be a mentor. With a little time and a big heart, you can make a difference in a young person's life. To find out how you can become a mentor, call America's Promise at 1-888-55-YOUTH. Every kid deserves a sporting chance.
NASCAR next week on CBS. First from Homestead, Winston Cup stars Mark Martin, Dale Jarrett, and Terry Labonte take on the best of the Grand Nationals, including Randy LaJoy at the Miami Jiffy Lube 300. Then from Vegas, Jack Sprague and Rich Bickle battle for the Truck Series Championship at the CarQuest Auto Parts 420K, all next weekend, next Sunday, right here on CBS Sports. Altel Stadium record crowd in attendance today, 84,297. And what a terrific game they are watching. Mark Johnson kicks off for Georgia. Bulldogs have the lead again. Bo Carroll, the second hesitation before running it out. And a good decision to bring it out as he's to the 27-yard line. Here's Michelle.
Well, guys, Georgia scored that last touchdown. Defensive coordinator Joe Kynes came over to his defensive bench and he shouted at the top of his lungs, if we play our game, guys, we'll win this. If we play our defense, this sucker's ours.
Well, Michelle, I'm glad you didn't say everything Joe Kine said. I've been on those sidelines before. Guarantee you there's a little intensity going on right now.
Has had the ball twice in the third quarter, scored a touchdown on each possession. Fred Taylor out to the 30. That's a gain of three on first down for Florida. Paul Snellings made the tackle.
Sean, going back to Michelle's report, Joe Kine is talking about is, hey, we don't want to give up big plays. The last drive that Florida had, the Georgia defense gave up more big plays than they had previously. That's what he's talking about. Keep the ball in front of us. No big plays.
As you see, now a final in Alabama. The Tide going down to Louisiana Tech. We can hear the rumbling all the way here in North Florida. Brindice underneath to Jimmy Richardson. Stopped well short of a first down by Greg Bright. And it'll be third down for Florida. The yard line to reach is the 37, and the ball's going to be spotted down to about the 33.
Well, it was a nice play by Greg Bright. He lined up wrong, then ran over to the proper side, and then made a real good tackle on the Florida Gator.
Big third down play. In the final seconds of the third quarter, third and four. Empty backfield. Brindice deep into coverage and incomplete. Jamie Richardson had three Bulldogs in the neighborhood.
That was the same play that they hit Jamie Richardson down the middle on earlier on their touchdown drive. Steve Spurrier went to it again, but boy, it was crowded down there. That was awfully close to an interception for Noah Brindice. Made sure to on there.
Coach likes to punt, but Steve Spurrier always seems absolutely disgusted when he has the punting unit onto the field.
I love about him. He's a perfectionist. He loves offensive perfection.
Line drive punt by Robbie Stevenson. Michael Greer, so the former Georgia All-American, Steve Greer. He returned to 12 yards out across the 30-yard line. That's the end of a wild third quarter. The score, Georgia 21, Florida 17. We'll return to Altel Stadium right after this message and a word from your local station.
With Plymouth, this is what you pay for, and this is what you get. For instance, at Ford Voyager, you get a minivan that handles just like a car, with front-wheel drive, power rack and pinion steering, and a great handling suspension. And this is what you pay. One more time. This is what you pay for, and this is what you get. Get up to $1,000 cash back on select Plymouth minivans. See your Plymouth dealer today.
Somewhere between amber and linen, there's heaven. Between heaven and earth, there's daylight. And if you follow daylight past sunrise and dawn, your eyes open to a color called morning. One of the colors between the colors created by Canon. Canon Laser Color. Its only competition is reality.
It's the greatest reunion in TV history. Bob Newhart and Judd Hirsch join the cast of Taxi, Newhart and More in a show that's
freaky.
George and Leo, CBS Monday.
For college football action, the address is CBS. Welcome home.
The main ingredient is Publix.
Big West Bacon Cheeseburger is with total concentration. That way you can appreciate all the things that make it so great. Like two big beef patties, three strips of bacon, melting cheese, a ton of barbecue sauce, and a huge steak. Big West Bacon Cheeseburger. Only at Hardee's.
Joggers.
Crime Team 12. Weeknights at 6 o'clock. Only on 12.
Start of the fourth quarter. Georgia, in search of its first victory over Florida since 1989, has the ball and a four-point lead. First and 10. Edwards. Out to the 38-yard line. Terry, the third quarter featured rather dramatic momentum shift. Florida came out flying, then Georgia got it back with a touchdown drive.
Well, when you're playing in one of these rivalry games, you always talk to your team about answering the bell. Respond to the adversity. When they do something, you come right back and do it again. And that's what both teams have done. Florida down by 11, responds. They come back. Georgia, all of a sudden, they respond and do.
Got five on first down. Now a Patrick pass following Chris Terry. And short of first down, tackled by Mike Harris. CBS Sports delighted to have you with us from Alltel Stadium in Jacksonville, Florida. They brought in 5,000 extra seats for this game. All the Marfield, the largest crowd ever in this stadium, 84,297. 75th or 76th meeting between these two schools, depending upon which school's history choose to follow. And it has been a scintillating game from the start. And a big play here. Third down and three for Georgia. Dogs at their own 39. Bobo throws. Hines Ward has it. Elijah Williams pulls him out of bounds at the 31-yard line. That's a big gainer of 30 for Georgia.
Ward came with a blitz. Hines Ward ran an inside route and ran away from Elijah Williams. He comes down the field. Now he crosses the field. Elijah Williams just can't stay with him. Mike Bobo delivers the ball. One of the ways to beat man coverage is when you start crossing people. Look at Mike Bobo. Is he on fire?
He's had a mistake-free second half, and that's important. Neither team has turned it over in the second half after a sloppy first half. Two tight ends in the game for Georgia. Edwards couldn't get outside, and what a terrific play by Willie Cowens to get off the block of Jermaine Wiggins and drop Edwards for the loss. Back at the 35-yard line, the scoring started with Robert Edwards from 27 yards on the run on the second possession of the game for Georgia. In the second quarter, Collins Cooper from 36 yards made it 7-3 after an interception set that up. Then Edwards, a one-yard run. It was 14-3 at the half. No Brindice in off the bench. The first drop resulted in a one-yard touchdown. The second drive of the half, a three-yard run by Frazier for TD in the first Florida lead of the game. And Robert Edwards had the lengthy drive of 78 yards for Georgia with his third touchdown of the ball. Now Bobo on second and long throws, nearly picked off. Tony George stepped in front of the pass intended for Hines Ward. Bobo got flattened as he delivered.
Ed Chester came in, put an awful lot of pressure on Mike Bobo. It looked like Mike Bobo kind of got his arm hurt there, shook up a little bit, but he's certainly going to stay in the ball game. When you're in the Georgia-Florida game, that kind of rivalry, they got to carry you off the field.
Bobo had completed seven in a row before that incompletion. Third down and 16. Georgia best this season in the SEC on third downs at 49%. Bobo handled the low snap and throws to Ward. He's open. He has it. Lunging for a first down. It looked like with the extra effort, he got them by about a half yard. Needed to get to the 21. The ball was inside the 21. Tico Brown made the tackle. 7 yards for Georgia.
Mike Bobo threw that ball where only Eagles dare to fly. Trust me. Tico Brown and Fred Weir
this pass, but Hines Ward goes up and makes the reception in the middle of traffic. Hines Ward certainly being a dominant factor, primary factor in this game today.
And he got the first down with about a half yard to spare. From the 20, first and 10, Georgia. The Bulldogs lead by four. Nearly 3 minutes played, fourth quarter. And it's Robert Edwards across the 20 and down at the 18. Johnny Rutledge made the tackle.
Sean, that play didn't gain very much, but what it did do, it ran right at the Florida defense. That's one of the ways to increase that defense. Attack it downhill, particularly with a big back like Robert Edwards. Turn him downfield on that defense.
Ward, after taking one play on the sideline, brings the play in from Jim Donnan. And that play involves Ward at quarterback, and Bobo lined up to the right as a wideout. Option left. Ward kicks, and Harris collars him at the 15. We'll need five more for a first down on third down for Georgia.
Credit Jim Donnan. He continues to mix up the offense, puts Hines Ward at quarterback, then puts him out at wide receiver. Watch number 13 in the middle of the defense. That's the guy, Mike Harris. He runs all around the field, and he makes the play on in the open field on Hines Ward. That's a big tackle. He might have run for a touchdown if he misses that tackle.
Play clock down to six. Ward, the quarterback again. Again, a short snap. He's up the middle with the first down. Hines Ward spinning down to the seven.
You talk about a great individual effort. This is a real effort by Hines Ward. The snap is low. He has to recover the low snap. Then he gets hit at the line of scrimmage, but he just fights and battles his way for the critical first down.
He seems to be exhausted on the sideline. 21 yards rushing, 81 receiving, 27 passing, and 69 return yards.
Florida's getting strained, getting lined up when Hines Ward goes to quarterback. Changes their defensive lineman a little bit. They want to get certain things against the option play called, and it's harder to get it done.
Deep handoff. Edwards in trouble and thrown for a loss. Big play by Willie Rogers with help from Elijah Williams up from the corner. That play goes back to the nine, a loss of two.
Just wasn't a lot of room to run here. Robert Edwards, the Florida defense, upfield. They played off blocks very well. Edwards gets forced to the sideline. Once you start running sideways, coaches, players say, West, you're in trouble. You got to go north and south.
With his 21 yards rushing today, over 1,000 yards rushing for his career. He's already 1,000 receiving. Trying to get over 1,000 passing from the first player in history to do it in all three categories. Bobo goes to Ward, and he's out of bounds just inside five. So it'll be third and goal for the Bulldogs. With 9:17 remaining in the fourth quarter, and Georgia leading by four. Huge difference between a touchdown and a field goal on this session for Jim Donnan's Dogs. The quarterback. Bobo again out to the right. 12th play of this drive. Looked like some movement before the snap, and whistles are blowing. This play will not stand. Looks like Larry Brown, the tight end, might have moved ahead of the snap. This is the first flag against either team in the second half, and just the fourth penalty to be enforced in the game.
John, that's exactly right. 87, Larry Brown jumped early.
Before the snap, false start on the offensive line. High ball penalty, third down.
Here he is right there, Larry Brown. He just got a little anxious and came out of there just a little early. It's
talk about a big penalty. Yeah. Boy, does that change the philosophy of the call and that sort of thing. All of a sudden now, you can't call with the same freedom that you were going to call.
Just the only benefit would be you do get a little more room to throw the football, run your routes. That's what you choose to do. Jim Dunn is going to take time out to think about it.
What are golfers saying about their Armor TI 100 irons?
Head size makes me feel confident. Can't miss hit these babies.
I've added 15 yards my iron play. I got my first hole in one with these clubs.
Oh, they rank above our cat and my old DCIs.
We'll take that as a compliment. Armor TI 100, the number one titanium iron on tour.
In 1984, two computer scientists envisioned the impossible, a seamless network of computer networks. They invented the router, and Cisco Systems was born. Out of Cisco came internetworking, and now directing millions of messages a day. Their equipment makes the internet possible. Cisco will be there as web users soar to 200 million by the year 2000. Where do you learn about companies so integrated into the future? Exactly. NASDAQ.com.
Let's see. Oh, it says you've been seen in the movies.
That should read at the movies.
And you've built models, but never really actually modeled. Well, quite frankly, you the man!
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Was she my co-star?
Now she is.
Cosby busts a move with rap star Busta Rhymes. But can Busta handle special guest Debbie Allen on an all-new Cosby, CBS Monday?
Another big play in this game, third and goal, Georgia at the 10-yard line. What do you look for, Terry?
Well, you have two players that are having big days, Hines Ward and Corey Allen. Those are the guys.
Both up to the top of the screen, and Tony Small joins him as he goes in motion. Bobo throws the other way. The pass is incomplete. Thrown behind Hines Ward. Tony George had the coverage. As we mentioned, a huge difference between a touchdown and a field goal. Jim Dunn dejectedly sent field goal out, and his kicking situation has been a little bit shaky. He's gone to Dax Langley today instead of the usual kicker, Hap Hines.
Hines Ward ran an inside run against man coverage, and you can see he's open. If the ball had been delivered properly, that might have been a touchdown, or certainly would have gotten the ball down about the 1 or 2 yard line. As you mentioned, John, this is a big kick, and they've not been great at field goal kicking this season thus far.
Dak Langley, 27-yarder. It is good. Jim Donnan changed kickers today. And Langley makes that move pay off. It's a one-touchdown lead for Georgia.
Eileen, she's been good to us. I reckon it's time Mike went to town and get us a new vehicle.
All right.
Leland, what has gotten into you?
I don't know, but I like it.
I've been alone. I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried.
For years, you've heard the debate.
Duracell. Energizer.
Which battery lasts longer?
Duracell.
Recent tests Energizer. Prove that Duracell outlasts Energizer.
Duracell.
Better make it the alkaline battery proof to last longer. Better make it Duracell.
I like being in control. With this new Dinarex, I control the cause of my dandruff every day.
New Dinarex Advanced Formula. Its medicine doesn't just treat the symptoms, it controls a leading cause of dandruff called Peel Valley.
Now that's serious control.
New Dinarex Advanced Formula.
NASDAQ College Football on CBS is sponsored by Nissan. Who reminds you that life is a journey. Enjoy the ride. Duracell. When it better work, better make it Duracell. And by the document company, Xerox.
13-play drive results a field goal of 27 yards by Langland. His first field goal of the season. He has done some place kicking each of the previous two seasons. Mark Johnson's kickoff down to Carroll. Will not get across the 10-yard line. Robert Arnott dropped him at the 9.
Not really a great decision by Bo Carroll to bring the ball out. He was pinned into the corner. Robert Arnott is a converted offensive player, just moved to defense a week ago, and they say he's really taken to his new linebacker position, and he's instinctive to the ball and comes up with a big special teams play right there.
Under 9 minutes remaining. Georgia by 7. Florida from its own 9, first and 10. Brindice, short pass, batted down. Travis Stroud, the senior from Atlanta, knocked that ball out of the air. Clicked on to CBS.Sportsline.com this week. Make your choice from our list of the greatest college football coaches of all time. Select from one of these nominees. Actually, you're going to select the nominees. Then tune into our game next weekend and find out who is the fan's choice in the CBS Sportline poll. I know who I choose.
I know who Andrew Donahue.
Same person I choose. Brindice, another deflected pass as he dropped back to the goal line. Looks like Antonio Cochran got a piece of that one. Not an inspired start to this possession for Florida. Third down and 10 from the 9-yard line.
Tough when you get backed up with such poor field position. It's hard sometimes to feel the freedom that you have when you have better field position. Georgia comes on a good twist under pressure, but really the ball just was poorly thrown.
Third and 10. Flag down to stop the play. Florida has been called for just one penalty today, and that was in the first half. This will be number 2.
Before the snap, false start on the offensive line. The penalties half the distance to goal line, third down.
And Steve Spurrier's team has really cut down on penalties today. They win. Second most penalized team of the conference. Only Arkansas has seen more flags. Brindice throws, and it is deflected and caught. An interception by Smart on the ricochet.
From the left side of the screen, he exerts the pressure on the quarterback. He gets his hands up. The ball is just poorly thrown behind. Once that ball starts getting tipped up in the air, that's the old tip drill for defensive backs. Just keep tipping the ball up in the air till somebody can come up with it. Excellent job with the tip drill by the Georgia secondary.
And Jacquez Green, it looked like it hit his hand, Glenn Ford's hands, and Smart at his second interception of the ball game. To the 25. Kirby Smart gets those interceptions in bunches. Earlier this season, he had 2 interceptions against South Carolina. Last week, we saw him pick off 2 passes against Kentucky. And now he has 2 today against Florida. Doug Dunn threw 2 INTs in the first half and did not start the second half. Brindice took over, and that's the first Florida turnover of the second half. The interception by Brindice, the first he has thrown this year.
Return, Sean.
Yeah,
the bad field position, the decision to bring the ball out. When you have that field position, it's just hard to run offense.
Second and eight. Bobo being the veteran quarterback, running the play clock down. Edwards out of bounds, chased out by Johnny Rutledge. Even a field goal here would be huge for Georgia. It would require two scores from Florida to come back. Bear in mind, just today, Jim Donnan has changed field goal kicker. Ball spotted to the 24-yard line. It'll be third down and seven. Georgia best in the conference on third downs for the season, and right at 50% again today. Out of the shotgun, Bobo. Four-man rush, well picked up. But finally, he runs out of time. Bobo stood back there for much too long, and that takes them out of field goal range. Willie Cohen's having a big game for the Florida defense.
It's a coverage sack by the Florida Gators and a bad decision by Mike Bobo. He had so much time that he just had too much time. Sooner or later, you have to feel like the timing of the route is broken down. Take the ball and get it back up into the line of scrimmage. You can see all these guys are covered by the Florida Gators. There's just nowhere for Bobo to get the ball to, but get the ball back to the line of scrimmage. Well, that's a huge, huge sack for Florida. And of course, they're the best in the SEC sack.
And it's huge because it takes them out of field goal range. And now the officials stop the action. With 6:47 left. Dax Langley on to punt. But Georgia looking at fourth down and 17.
Dead ball. Delayed offense. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
And now fourth and 22.
Good penalty by Georgia. Run the clock. Go ahead. It doesn't hurt your kicker at all. Might help him.
Dax Langley to punt to Dakota. Likely will try to get it out of bounds. A little too much angle on that one. It goes out at the 20. Well, just the same as if he had kicked it in the end zone. A 20-yard pile of Langley.
Business is a race. For a head start, the Xerox DocuColor 40 lets you print or copy 40 color pages in just 60 seconds. Because in the business world, the tortoise never wins. The Document Company, Xerox.
This year, Nissan has performed a little magic on the new Altima. We made it roomier, we made it quieter, and we made it sleeker. But the real trick was making it for less. How? Sorry, magicians never reveal their secrets. The new Nissan Altima, starting at $15,079.90, with a lot of stuff.
The CBS Star of College Football Today is sponsored by Nissan, who reminds you that life is a journey. Enjoy the ride.
We have candidates for the star, Chris Wallace, Toledo. You have some to consider, too.
Tim Rattay, the quarterback, upsets Alabama with three touchdown passes. How about Mississippi State's defense? They shut out Auburn for a big win.
To me, the star of the day is from Tennessee. And when you say one individual picked the team up, carried them on the shoulder, you think it was Peyton Manning. But no, it was Jamal Lewis, a freshman. 25 carries, 205 yards. He's the star of the day for many days to come.
Don't you bet Phil Fulmer wished he had discovered him in time for the Florida game. Now, back to the game.
And this game is a dandy, and look at this. Doug Johnson is back in at quarterback. He started, played the first half through two interceptions. And Florida trailed by 11 at the break. He slings it deep. Look out. That could have been easily intercepted. It was not by Larry Mann. Mann looked like a center fielder waiting for a fly ball to come down. That's not what Steve Spurrier had in mind when he put Johnson back in. He was looking. Doc was green with Doc Johnson.
That ball was really going up for grabs, and if Georgia had come down, Larry Mann, number one, if he had come down with that interception, would have been a tough, tough thing for Florida to overcome.
And the two touchdowns in the third quarter, absolutely nothing on offense for Florida here in the fourth. 6.5 minutes remaining. Johnson with a lot of time. That pass batted down. Greg Bright has been outstanding today, dropping back into pass coverage. Again, Jacquez Green was the intended target.
Well, the Florida line did a great job giving Johnson all the time in the world to throw that particular ball. And as you mentioned, Sean, Greg Bright came underneath the throw and knocked it down. Tremendous play from his linebacker position.
Bright, one of the seniors, with this last chance to defeat Florida. Third down and 10. 6:23 remaining, Georgia by 7. Johnson throws, and it is incomplete. Looking for Travis McGriff. And Ronald Bailey had very tight coverage. No sign of the offense coming off the field, but now Steve Spurrier sends the punt team out. Certainly much too early to think about going for it on 4th and 10 at your own 20.
Travis McGriff runs down the field, turns around. Ronald Bailey is all over him. He's throwing a covered receiver. That guy is covered.
Bailey was the defensive player of the week last week in the SEC. 18 tackles, an interception return for a touchdown against Kentucky. He was on the field for all 90 plays that the Kentucky offense had. He was the only Georgia defender to play all 90. Robbie Stevenson with the punt. Michael Greer caught it on the run. He's inside the 40. Great field position for Georgia as Greer brought it back to the 37-yard line, a 17-yard return. Aaron Kinney made the tackle on the redshirt freshman from Athens, Georgia. The best seat in the house today is inside the Bud One airship. Aerial ambassador, the King of Beers.
No, that was a low punt, Sean. It wasn't hung up there very high. That enabled Georgia to field the ball and get real advantageous field position. That ball just shot off the punter's foot.
And 6 minutes left. Again, even a field goal would be a huge lift to Georgia's upset hopes. It would require Florida to score twice. Edwards got around Owens. Walks down the sideline. He's going to go! Touchdown!
This is the play that hurt Florida earlier in the game. The toss sweep to the open end side. And Hines Ward out there making a great block as a wide receiver enabled Edwards to scoot down the sideline for the touchdown.
37 yards. That's the fourth rushing touchdown of the day for Edwards. The extra point no good. Langley's try hit the left upright. So it's a 13-point game with 5:58, a lot of time remaining on the Alltel Stadium clock.
Boy, it's just never easy to win. It's hard to win a game. And here Georgia looks like it's going to be a nice, easy extra point. And Kareem's off the upright. Oh, I'll tell you what, if you're Jim Donovan, you're just dying inside when this thing has happened. But boy, I'll tell you, I go back to the block by Hines Ward out of the perimeter against Elijah Williams, 25. Hines Ward has done it all. Yeah, that's Robert Edwards on the touchdown. He's had a great day, but so is number 19, Hines Ward.
Second time in his career, Edwards has had 4 touchdowns in the game. He did it against South Carolina back in 1995. He's on roll. 180 yards rushing last week against Kentucky. Over 100 again today with 4 TDs.
And he's a running back, Sean, has been hurt so much in his career. You got to be happy for that guy. I mean, he started the season the very first time he touched the ball this year in game competition, he hurt his ankle.
And for those who aren't familiar with his career history. He started his career, played 2 years as a cornerback. Ray Goff moved him to running back. Thaddeus Bullard, a defensive lineman, returning that squib kick to the 28-yard line. Matter of fact, when Ray Goff summoned Edwards to his office in spring practice, and you see Jesse Palmer will be the third different quarterback of the day for Florida, Robert Edwards told us, I was sitting outside in the hall saying, what did I do wrong? Why does he want to talk to me?
Usually when the head coach calls in the office, you've done something wrong, or it's position change. Mm-hmm. In Robert Edwards' case, it was simply a position change.
Now Palmer, who started the Auburn game, didn't play particularly well and was relieved by Brindis. Taylor might have been by the face mask because he was dropped for a loss. Flag was thrown near the tackle. It's also possible that one of the Florida offensive linemen reached out and grabbed a face mask. Perhaps just a black sheep.
You know, that's exactly what happened. Number 77, Justin Blackshear, grabbed number 51, Brandon Miller.
Mm-hmm. It is going to be a face mask, but we think it's on the offense.
It's a good call by the official.
And back to the Gators.
Personal foul. Face mask on the offense. The penalty being on the spot of the foul, half the distance to the goal line.
Watch the right guard right there, Cheston Blackshear. He has a hold of the face mask. Mm-hmm. You can see it clearly as anything. It's a good call. Brandon Miller came upfield on a great pass rush move and beat him.
Miller got a great jump off the snap.
Almost looks like he was offside.
Yes, it did. 5:40 remaining. Middle screen for Taylor. He's out to the 20. But a long way to go for a first down. They need to reach the 38-yard line. A long time since Georgia had a win against the top 10 opponent back in 1991 when the Bulldogs beat number 6 Clemson. Florida started this day ranked 6th in the nation. Georgia number 14. Second down 15. Bulldogs have a 13-point lead with 5 minutes remaining. And that pass is short in the face, Kareem. Ronald Bailey has covered. Palmer's a true freshman from the Paint, Ontario, native Canadian. We told you during the Auburn game, Brandon Miller going off with an apparent shoulder injury. The Florida coaches came aware of Palmer when his dad, who was a fine linebacker in the Canadian Football League, sent the tape of Jesse playing in football games in Canada to the coaching staff. They liked what they saw, invited him down for a visit. He wound up enrolling at the University of Florida. And it looked like Travis Stroud came across the line early. On third down, 13, he was a little bit anxious to get after the quarterback.
Well, that's a big penalty right there, too. Now, all of a sudden, the conversion is a great deal easier with that extra 5 yards.
Penalty's 5 yards.
It'll be third down and 13 now. It's third and 18 prior to the penalty.
You can watch Travis Stroud. He just gets a little anxious to get onto that quarterback.
Musical chairs at quarterback today. For Florida, in a very tough spot for the true freshman Palmer, who threw two interceptions in that start against Auburn 2 weeks ago without a touchdown pass. Third and 13. Palmer dumps it off. Low. Taylor couldn't catch it. Now we'll see what Steve Spurrier will do. Down by 13 with under 5 minutes remaining. Looking at fourth down and 13.
Steve's going to go for this. I'd be shocked if he punts the ball. He's going to go for it. He needs to try. He knows the game's out of reach if he doesn't convert it anyway, so it's really not a gamble. You just have to go and try and make the first down.
And another problem for Florida, just one timeout remaining. Each team has one timeout.
Florida playing a lot of underneath man-to-man coverage right now with safeties on top. It's not an easy defense to attack. There's not a lot of seams to hit players in.
And now with some confusion and the play clock running out, Florida has used its last timeout.
The worst was I'd be at a party and someone would light a cigarette and that cigarette would look like filet mignon to me. My mouth would practically... Without an cigarette gum, I could never have quit. I could chew a piece when I needed it and I would regain control and it would soothe my cravings fast. After a piece of cigarette, a cigarette would only look like top round to me. And that, I could resist.
Nicorette gum can fight your cravings, your habit, your way. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
In 1984, two computer scientists envisioned the impossible, a seamless network of computer networks. They invented the router, and Cisco System was born. Out of Cisco came internetworking, and now directing millions of messages a day. Their equipment makes the internet possible. Cisco will be there as web users soar to 200 million by the year 2000. Where do you learn about companies so integrated into the future? Exactly. NASDAQ.com.
Cloth stands between the police and the witnesses.
You want to rain a terror out there?
All New Brooklyn South, CBS Monday.
Well, here's the latest big play in a game filled with big plays. Fourth down and 13 for Florida. In their own 25, trailing by 13, under 5 minutes remaining and no timeouts left for the Gators. Palmer throws too high and it's incomplete. Off the shoulder pads of Smart. Don't know if he meant to drop that, but if he did, it is truly a smart play because they'll get the ball back at the 27-yard line. Smart nearly had his third interception of the game. Ball spotted at the 25. First and 10, Georgia takes over on down.
You got to give Joe Kynes, the defensive coordinator at Georgia, some real credit today. Last week, he did a great job against Kentucky, keeping them out of the end zone. This week, against a good Florida team, he only gives up 17 points. There just wasn't a lot of places to throw the ball, but Steve Spurrier really being frustrated right now with the play of the quarterback position.
Safe play, as you might expect. Wasn't particularly safe for Gary, as he got drilled by Mike Harris and Tony George. Check that. It was Callaway, 32, not 22.
Now, if you're Jim Dunn and you're just telling your quarterback, bleed the clock. Make sure that on every single play, the clock runs all the way through the 25-second count. You've got to, at the same time, you can't pull the reins in totally yet because not just bleed it, be positive, keep pounding away. You're moments away from the biggest win that you've had in Georgia.
Georgia fans were grumbling about Jim Donnan last year when he went 5-6 in his first year as coach. He'll be the toast of Georgia tonight if his team can finish the job, and they're moving closer as Edwards has a first down. Well, here is what the standings look like in the SEC Eastern Division at the moment with Tennessee's win. We haven't yet conceded this win to Georgia. There's still 4 minutes to play. But now Tennessee moves into the driver's seat if this score stands because the Volunteers defeated Georgia. That's the one loss for Georgia in the conference and for the season, a loss at Tennessee. And Steve Spurrier's told us a number of times in the last couple of weeks he believes Tennessee's going to win out, and he felt his team had to win out to have any chance at fifth straight SEC title. Mike Harris, the injured player, being helped up to the Florida sideline. Another streak in jeopardy. Florida has been ranked in the AP top 10 in each of the last 81 polls. That's the longest streak in the country for a team being in the top 10. They were starting the day Wonder if they drop out of the top 10.
Well, they might drop out of the top 10, but think about that. What a stream that is. You got to give Spurrier and the Gators some real credit. I mean, in the 90s with the scholarship limitations, to me, it's unfathomable how a guy can do that. I just don't understand.
He's trying to help Doug Johnson with a pound in the back, but it seems to me he needs to make some decisions. Perhaps part of the problem with this offense is the interchangeable parts, quarterbacks in and out, linemen in and out, coaches being chastised publicly. Certainly is not a tranquil situation.
Boy,
in Gainesville.
John, this is a big thing by Georgia. They have to use a timeout.
Well, the play clock was down to zero, and snap had not come.
Boy,
Jim Dunn is saying, "Wow."
Yeah, I think Jim didn't feel the ball was marked where his players were alert enough to see the ball marked for play when the injured player was taken back off the field. I'm not sure, but boy, I'll tell you, I hate to time out in this situation.
Main man today for Georgia, along with Robert Edwards, who scored four touchdowns, has been Hines Ward. A triple threat is actually a quadruple threat when you throw in this aspect. The return game, and he set the tone for the game with a 50-yard return of the opening kickoff. He played some quarterback. He threw a pass off a reverse. He's had seven catches today for 85 yards. He's run the option, 21 yards rushing on five carries. One out of two passing, 27 yards, 203 total yards today.
And I think you have to give Jim Donnan credit, Sean, the way he's used Hines Ward today. He just hasn't gone with Mike Bobo all afternoon. He's had Hines Ward a real active part of this offensive attack.
After the timeout, first and 10 from the 12-yard line. 3.5 minutes remaining. Olandis Gary up the middle. To the seven. We've talked about Ward's quest to become the first player in NCAA Division I-A history with 1,000 career yards in each of the three categories, receiving, rushing, and passing. And he went over 1,000 yards rushing today. He's 82 in passing. He also has a chance in return. Even if he gets it in just the first three, he'll be the first player to do that.
You know what I like about him, too, is that here's a guy that came thinking he was a quarterback. Then he got moved to tailback. Then he got moved to wide receiver, and he's still out there plugging away for the Bulldogs. You know, he hasn't let all these changes affect him.
Landis Gary inside the five, breaks through tackles and goes into the end zone. Touchdown, Georgia! Touchdown run for Olandis Gary, the junior from Washington, D.C., who transferred from Marshall University when Jim Donnan came here as coach. Florida was giving up an average of 41 yards per game rushing to its opponents. Georgia's rush for 144. Dax Langley likes that left upright, but this one managed to sneak through, and it's a 20-point lead for the Georgia Bulldogs.
John, I've been on both sides of this kind of a game. When you win it, there's no greater feeling in all the world, and there's a lot of frustration on that Georgia sideline finally ended today. On the other side, if you're Florida, you got to come back, you got to regroup. You have to understand that this Florida team is not as strong as some of the ones in the past, but you still have some exciting football ahead of you.
Georgia and Tennessee move to the forefront of the race in the Eastern Division of the Southeastern Conference. There's the road ahead for Georgia. Auburn in a couple of weeks in Athens. Auburn coming off a loss today. And that Ole Miss out of the conference against their rival Georgia Tech. Johnson squibs it again. Eugene McCaslin runs it to the 33. 2:33 remaining. Florida down by 20. 37-17. It'll be Jesse Palmer again at quarterback. There will be no defense of the national championship for the Gators, barring a miracle now over the final 2.5 minutes. And if what Steve Spurrier said holds true about Tennessee winning out, no chance at a fifth straight conference crown as well. Palmer pitched it back to Bo Carroll. That's a gain of 10, very near a first down. And let's look at the remaining schedule for the Gators. Vanderbilt at home on homecoming. That'll be a glum gathering. At South Carolina. And then Florida State in Gainesville. All kinds of numbers around this game. And another one will not be achieved. Steve Spurrier's 100th career coaching victory. Combining his record at Duke and Florida. Looking for a career coaching win number 100, and this is 11th season as a college head coach. He won't get there. That pass is short of Aaron Kinney. Glenn Ford had the cover. Post game show coming up, scores and highlights. Another terrific performance by Joe Pink's defense for the second straight week against two of the best offenses in the nation.
What a job they did on Jaquez Green. They took Jaquez Green and made him a role player today. He wasn't a primary performer.
Third down and a yard. The Bulldogs have to give them the short pass to Aaron Kinney. The defensive backs playing about 20, 25 yards off the wide receivers of Florida.
You know, they also, Joe Kynes' defense at Georgia also limited Fred Taylor. Fred Taylor had a good day, but none of those big plays that just crush it. He wanted to make sure they didn't give up a lot of big plays, and they didn't.
That was the first down this quarter for Florida. From the 50-yard line, back on the ground with Bo Carroll. And he's tripped up after picking up another first down at the 37-yard line of Georgia. Time is running out. 1:27 left. A 20-point lead. And finally, a victory in his senior year, Mike Bobo, against the Florida Gators.
What a win for Jim. And such a nice man. He's been so nice to us. Steve Spurrier has been. But, I mean, you know, it gives his program a real jump start after 2 years. You know, people are going to look and say, hey, Joey on a roll now.
Palmer lofting it to the end zone. And that one is intercepted. Larry Mann had the coverage on Travis Taylor. That's the second interception for Larry Mann this season, the sophomore from Atlanta, Georgia.
I think when Florida looks back on this game, they're going to look at the LSU game and say, hey, the turnovers killed us. They're going to look at the Georgia game, they're going to say, the turnovers killed us.
Four interceptions in each game, each of the two losses for Florida.
It's hard to win when you turn it over that often if you're not just clearly better than the other team. There's just not a lot of room to throw into that secondary. The DBs are back, they're soft. It's tough on a guy like Jesse Palmer to find anywhere to go with the ball.
New quarterback for England, the freshman from Duluth, Georgia. He pitched it to Patrick. And now some tempers flaring at the play. Pass got two out to the 22. Under a minute remaining. And the clock running down on Jim Donnan's biggest win in his two seasons at Georgia. He's had other great wins, won a national championship at Marshall. Florida side empty, but look at the Georgia side. They're all here to savor their first win over the Gators since 1989. And they'll have the bragging rights tonight as the world's largest outdoor cocktail party continues, and they don't have to run another play. Jim Donnan and Steve Spurrier, a lot of respect for each other. They played against each other in the mid-60s when Donnan was a quarterback at NC State. Spurrier was at Florida. And there's Michelle with the very happy Jim Donnan. Michelle?
Coach, you guys came into this game underdog. Everyone said you had... You had hadn't been tested yet except by Tennessee, and you lost that one. A big test. And it seems like your entire team came up.
I just want to say for the fans all over, waiting a long time, it was a great victory for us. Our kids really played hard, and, you know, I'm just so happy for everybody that believed in me and let me get this job, but our kids really deserve it.
So many implications here. You saw Florida 7-3 in the series. You advanced 10-1, and you changed the outlook in the SEC East. What's most important about this win?
Our defense put a lot of pressure on the quarterback, did a good job of moving around, and offensively, we were a little out of sync in the first half, but we really made some nice drives there and put the game away. But it's a great feeling for me and for our players, and you know what? This has to be something else. I'm happy. I can't think real good here.
I'll tell you what. We'll take the pressure off you. Congratulations, Coach. We will turn to one of your seniors.
Hey, one thing CBS needs to know, we kept that game pretty close in the fourth quarter. They were a little worried about it, weren't you?
Not at all, Coach. We turn now to Hines Ward, one of the seniors who has waited so long. You were so critical in this win today, you and Robert Edwards with his four touchdowns. But you were able to throw so many looks at Florida's defense. Talk about what it was like to play in this game.
It was tremendous for the team. It was a great team effort. And Coach Donnan put me in a lot of different, you know, he used me in a lot of different ways to go out and try to throw Florida defense off. And, you know, today was a total team victory today. So we went out and we executed, and, you know, I think this is the best game we've played in the last 5 or 6 years. So, I mean, we're going to enjoy this, and this will be a great one.
Congratulations. I know you seniors have been waiting a long time for this.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we took, you know, I think the seniors really showed the dedication to this team and really helped lead this team to go out and play today. And that's what they came out and did today.
Congratulations, Hines. Let's send out a Sean McDonough.
Well, if you're a Bulldog fan, those were great pictures at which you were looking. Final score, Georgia 37 and Florida 17. The play continues in Jacksonville for Michelle Tafoya and Terry Donahue. I'm Sean McDonough saying so long from Alltel Stadium. Let's return you down to New York and Jim Nance.
All right, Sean, Terry, and Michelle, if you think there's a celebration for the Georgia fans, you ought to see what they're doing in Knoxville right now. What a shocker. Georgia wins at 37-17, and this completely blows up the whole landscape of college football and the bowl picture and the picks we made in the pregame show. I mean, what about this win? What an impressive show by the Jim Donnan's team today.
Yeah, reshuffle the whole deck. And I tell you what this does. If you're a college football fan, which we all are, if you're watching, I would suspect, you look right now, there are about 12 teams in the country who have a real chance in the month of November to get inside the Alliance. Can you only imagine if guys are running up and down the field having a chance to find out if there are 20 teams to get inside 16 teams in a playoff? Get the playoff going so that the bowl games really mean something, not just one or two.
And let's show you what this means now in the SEC Eastern Division. And Peyton and Tennessee, they have head-to-head against Georgia, having beaten the Bulldogs. It could be Tennessee perhaps in the line for a national championship game in the Orange Bowl. Who knows? But they're back in the race there, Lou.
If there's one thing we know, that each and every Saturday is like falling on a grenade. You never know exactly what's going to happen. There's a lot of football to be played.
That's why you need to play it on the field. Nobody thought, I didn't think, that Georgia would beat Florida today. Let the players win it.
By the way, the West is also pretty wild in the SEC because Mississippi State today blanked Auburn, and there are three teams now with two losses in the standings in the conference, Auburn, Mississippi State, and LSU.
All Mississippi State has to do is just win out. Their defensive performance today and the confidence that they have right now, Jackie Schell has done a tremendous job of keeping his ball club focused and on track.
He's really done a great job because he has quite a few junior college football players on this team, and it's hard to bring them together in just a short period of time.
Absolutely.
All right. Oklahoma embarrassed today by Nebraska as well. Elsewhere, last year the Sooners suffered their worst loss in history, a 52-point setback to Nebraska. Make it 62 today. Tom Osborne collects his 250th win, fastest to ever get there in college football history.
This is the show me play for future opponents here. This is Scott Frost and Bobby Newcomb for the touchdown. Football. Scott Frost today, I saw him running the ball. He was strong. And then Joel Mekavica. You talk about power. Nebraska is back with the power game. The victory against Washington. Remember, there were eight different players on defense that had to be replaced. Nebraska, the black shirts, they're back. Get ready.
Where is Oklahoma right now, Lou? This is just a disgrace.
Yeah, they're so far low, they have been on tiptoe.
That's all you can say. They outcoached us, outplayed us. And give them credit. This is their day. Day belongs to the Bucks.
You had tried so many things to light a fire under your team, under all aspects, in particular your quarterbacks. How much did that quarterback situation get thrown into?
Well, obviously, I keep thinking we can throw the ball around the way we used to, and maybe now I've learned we can't. So we thought we could get the ball here, there, and the other, but it just didn't work out. So I called a lousy game, and maybe we need to regroup, tighten up, and